Partly cloudy, 23 today with the 6 o'clock news. I'm Mel Usher.
I recognise, though, given the situation, I cannot deliver the mandate on which I was elected by the Conservative Party. I have therefore spoken to His Majesty the King to notify him that I am resigning as leader of the Conservative Party.
Liz Truss is bowing out after just 45 days as UK Prime Minister. She'll stay on in a caretaker role until a new leader is announced. Her controversial economic policies were her undoing. Ms Truss says she set out a vision for a low-tax, high-growth economy, but recognises that's no longer possible. An apparent hit run at Murray Bridge East is under investigation. A woman was struck by a car on the Old Princes Highway last night. It happened around 9:45. Major changes to shop trading hours in SA have been welcomed by retailers. New legislation will allow shops to open from 9 a.m. on Sundays and suburban stores to trade on Boxing Day. Roger Drake from Drake Supermarkets says the changes strike the right balance.
I think it's common sense, and if I talk to my counterparts in Victoria, the independents, they think we've got the best trading hours in the country.
More than 850,000 Aussies are almost $2,000 worse off because they're not switching their super fund to a high-performing one. Industry Super Australia data shows those who remained with a dud fund have lost a combined $1.6 billion and will be down on average $225,000 at retirement. Infectious diseases experts say adapting vaccines to emerging variants of COVID won't work in the long term. Vaccines are only just now being updated to provide protection against Omicron subvariants BA4 and 5, but there are now fears about new strains appearing overseas, which could become dominant in Australia. Dr. Paul Griffin says we need a vaccine that provides broader protection.
There are lots of clinical trials of even better vaccines. There's over 125 in clinical trials, and hopefully some of those will be better at doing things like stopping transmission to a higher degree and needing to be updated less frequently than the vaccines we have at the moment.
The Powerball has jackpotted after no one's numbers came up last night. Next week it'll be worth a record $160 million. Australians are being encouraged to find new ways to get more legumes into their diet. A new report by the Heart Foundation reveals one in two Aussies are not confident cooking with the food group. The Heart Foundation's senior dietitian Gemma O'Hanlon says there's a quick and easy way to get more of them into our diet.
Hummus is big on trend at the moment, and it's something that we can all take to our picnics or coming into summer entertaining. It's a great dip to have ready to go. Obviously, it's based on chickpeas and is a wonderful dip with some veggie sticks.
Now to 5AA Sport.
All new 2022 Mitsubishi Outlander with 10-year warranty, 10 years capped price servicing at Agostino Mitsubishi.
And it's hello and good morning, and we didn't win last night.
It's not good, but the silver lining is there's always next week. Especially
we will win next week.
Well,
we
exactly,
will.
Exactly, the biggest one. That's cannot wait for that. Let's start with cricket. Josh Inglis has been ruled out of Australia's T20 World Cup campaign. The backup wicketkeeper sliced open his hand when a club snapped during a round of golf. Coach Andrew McDonald says it was an unfortunate accident.
Totally devastated. Cut my hand and, just clubs dug in sharply and, the shaft snapped, so it's probably unheard of. Luckily, there's no tendon damage as well, so it's a pretty short turnaround, but unfortunately, just the timing of it.
All-rounder Cameron Green replaces Inglis. The campaign begins tomorrow with a clash against New Zealand. Two games in the World Cup yesterday, with Sri Lanka qualifying for the main stage after beating the Netherlands, who also go through that win by 16 runs, while the UAE took care of Namibia by 7 runs in the late game. And today, it's the West Indies up against Ireland, while Zimbabwe will take on Scotland. To football, Adelaide will take on Geelong tonight in a crucial top four defining clash at Unley Oval. The Crows will have to do it without skipper Chelsea Randall, who's out with an ankle injury. Meantime, St Kilda is expected to announce Ross Lyon as coach as early as today. To basketball, the Adelaide 36ers will take on league leaders, the Sydney Kings, tonight. And in the NBA, Josh Giddey had 14 points and 11 rebounds, but it wasn't enough as his Oklahoma went down by 7 points to Minnesota. Patty Mills and Ben Simmons also had a loss for Brooklyn. They went down by 22 points. And in the English Premier League, Fulham is leading Aston Villa 1-0 heading into the second half, while Leicester is 1-0 up against Leeds midway through the first half. And that's the 5AA Sport.
Now the 5AA forecast, partly cloudy, 23 for your Friday, a shower or two tomorrow, 21, Sunday a shower or two, 18, Monday a possible shower, also 18. Right now it's 17 degrees, more news as it happens on 5AA.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings, 5AA Breakfast.
Good morning to you, welcome to Friday, 6 after 6. David and Lucy, day two.
How are you, Lucy?
You're good. You've decided to keep me in the job. Happy to have you back.
Very much so. I was talking to Mum last night, and she said, "Tell Lucy she's doing a sensational job." So you've got the Carolyn Penberthy seal of approval, Lucy. You're off to a flyer. That's all that matters.
What about Lloyd Penberthy? Did your dad have any thoughts?
Yeah, well, Dad's more sort of self-deprecating. He's not a man prone to overstatement. But he said, "Oh, she was good. She was good."
I'll take it.
Which, coming from my old man, is an A+. So.
Yeah, no, I'd happily receive that from Lloyd.
How about your folks? They would have been listening.
They're on a lovely holiday up in Noosa at the moment.
Oh, really?
And have run into about 10 football players this week alone up there.
Because your old man was a footballer of some note, played for the mighty Fitzroy Lions,
didn't
he?
That's right, back in the 80s. But they're having a lovely week, but yes, they tuned in.
So they must have been...
I hope they told all their AFL buddies up there.
Oh, yeah. Hey, what a day yesterday was.
Oh, my gosh.
Particularly for our good friend Will and his lovely wife, Alison, as their family increased in number from 2 to 3.
And let me tell you, we waited all day for news, all day, and it didn't come until nearly 4 p.m. Now, we should preface as well, we don't know the time it was born. She was born. Little Rosie Mae Goodings.
Yep.
We don't know the time she was born yet, so we therefore don't know who won nearest to the pin comp.
This is going to be good.
It is going to be good because I'm with a chance to being nearest because I guessed last night at 9:15 p.m. Now I cannot win, obviously, but
no, because we're never eligible to win anything here.
No, but we still actually, and I even texted Will. Now he's been very busy, obviously, in a little loving family bubble and hasn't responded to too many messages, which is fine. But all I want to know is the time.
Yeah.
All I want to know is the time.
Well, we only found out at about 3 o'clock, didn't we?
Yeah, it was after 3 p.m. Yep.
So there were three guesses for yesterday, apart from yours, Luz.
Yep.
Steve from Adelaide, he guessed 10:20 a.m. Greg West Croydon guessed 11:45 a.m. And Jane from Edwardstown guessed 4:17 p.m. So it's pretty much between Greg and Jane, isn't it?
I think so. Now,
Did you pick a time, just out of interest?
No, 9:15 p.m. I was. So,
No.
But if it was after the 11:45 one, do we go nearest or do we go closest without going over?
I think we just do closest by the minute.
Yeah. So we're waiting still with bated breath, not for the name anymore, but for when little Rosie Mae was born. But I would like to share with you that I correctly guessed the name.
Oh, what about that?
And I said to our boss, Craig, on Wednesday in his office, I said, "Craig, I've worked it out. I think it's Rosie."
See, I was miles off with Consuela.
I mean, but you
had
a crack.
I just had a weird feeling it was going to be Consuela. Named after a Mexican housemaid we used to have.
Sam thought it was Reggie.
When I lived in Mexico, I stress.
I mean...
Reggie!
So I've been trying to guess for the past 19 weeks, and every day I'd just say a name at will, and he wouldn't give anything away, but I had a few clues.
Say a name at will, at will.
Yeah, I'd just be like, Laura, Emma... Emily, see if
did
you
have
react.
One of those baby naming books? Is that what
I
you
didn't.
Were using?
No, I was just trying to come up with them. And I managed to get some clues out of him. So one of them was that they used to work at the Nova Adelaide office. Now, I've been here for 5 years, and I was really hoping it was someone who'd left
Fitzy.
In the past five. Yeah, Fitzy.
Fitzy Goodings.
Little baby Fitzy. The other one was I didn't think it was going to be an E. Because there's a lot of E's in Will's family. I didn't think they wanted another one. Or a G, because there's Graham Goodings, but there's only one GG. There couldn't be another one.
Yeah, that's true. So they couldn't have called it Gwyneth.
I mean, I don't mind Gwyneth. Little Gwen.
Gwendolyn.
Gwen Goodings. The big clue for me, though, was I took a stab and I said, "Don't tell me it's something real random like juniper or eucalyptus." As a total joke, he said, "You know what? That's the closest clue you've got."
Oh, okay.
So that led me to think that
it was pushing into the floral...
Like a plant shrub.
Sphere.
Which leads you to lily, daisy, poppy, rosy.
Yeah.
So then on... And my final clue was I said, can you have a long version of the name or a short version of the name? Like you could call your child Charlie instead of Charlotte. So therefore, Rosie instead of Rosemary.
Yeah, of course.
So on Wednesday, I went into Craig's office and I said, I reckon it's Rosie.
Yeah.
And I should have bought a Powerball
you
ticket.
You should have. Oh.
Well, I still can because it didn't go off.
What about that? I was at the pub last night with a few mates. Thought, you know, we'd do the right thing and on Will's behalf, celebrate the birth of Rosie May. And it's funny because I don't think I've ever talked about Lotto with any of my friends in my entire life. And two of them were there checking their numbers in real time. I think it was the most number of tickets ever purchased in Australian history yesterday.
Yeah, well,
so God knows what it's going to be next week.
Yeah, $160 million.
So this is the biggest prize ever, isn't it?
Yeah, it's never happened in the 26-year history of
Powerball. Unbelievable. But you should buy a ticket, Lise, after your staggering efforts.
Can't
believe
that.
To get the name and the day.
Yeah. I'm pretty proud of that effort, to be honest.
Beautiful photograph.
It's a gorgeous photograph.
And the person I look at first, not the goofy dad standing there looking like he's just had a near-death experience, it's the mum. Alison looks great in that photo.
She looks very pleased.
Oh, yeah. Yes, pleased is the word.
Pleased and happy. She's very happy. And
gorgeous little baby.
Yeah, you can jump onto our Facebook and Instagram and Twitter pages to see photos of the Goodings' new little family.
It's nice to start the program. A lot of women in the headlines overnight. You got your Liz Truss. You got your Lydia Thorpes. We'll be getting to both of them shortly, but we thought we'd kick it off with Rosie May.
I know. Another day where something happens overnight and you see it at 3 o'clock and you go, oh, yep, UK again.
We was going to keep today's paper, or yesterday's paper.
Yesterday's paper.
What was the front page of yesterday's paper? It was a story about...
Gosh.
I can never remember.
Nope.
I can never remember. People say, what was on the show yesterday? And I go...
Total blur.
Don't know.
Total blur.
I've got no idea.
In good news.
I can remember the day my daughter was born, Sophie. She was born in... I can't do things backwards. What was it? 2002 she was born. The front page headline of the local paper that day was Saddam's Allies, where John Howard had accused anti-war protesters who were planning mass national protests against the war in Iraq of effectively backing Saddam Hussein as the Iraqi president. Saddam's Allies, and I got it. I did get it framed because the guys at work, they changed the headline and put a little strap over the top and it said, Sophie Penmer, the arrival edition.
That's nice.
So she's got it in her bedroom. So yesterday's paper was Land of Flooding Pains with the picture of the Lake Gardner. That's a memorable thing.
Of course.
Middle of the Murray River floods.
Now, of course, Little Rosie is the inspiration for our meat tray. It is Meat Tray Friday today. Thanks to Dane and the team at Blackwood Country Meats. They are on Main Road up in Blackwood. And we thought it's got to be baby themed.
Yeah, totally.
It's got to be name themed, considering, again,
absolutely,
how correctly I guessed.
Now, what the idea we had was, who were you named after?
Mine's a short story. No one. I'm not named after anyone memorable.
You know, funnily enough, I was actually named after David Hasselhoff, except he wasn't famous when I was born. Mum just had this weird hunch that he was going to be famous one day.
Really?
No,
I mean, and
that is completely not true.
But I was going to say, well, look at you now compared to the Hoff.
No, I'm like you, Lise. I wasn't named after anybody either.
No.
Mum and Dad just like the name. They're like classic traditional names.
Yep.
Probably a bit like your folks, I guess. Lucy's a good classical name.
Yeah, well, I'm Lucinda, but my other options were Charlotte or Sophie. So
what about that? Well, I got a Sophie, and my niece is Charlotte. Charlotte's a great name.
There you go. But we want to hear any story, even if you're named after your great uncle who
if it was your uncle who was in POW or
your mum was in labour watching a movie and you got named after the actor or
something
crazy like that. We want to hear it.
So people who are named after other people, that's what we're after.
That's
not
it.
People like Luce and I who are named after nobody.
I really like my name and I like your name, but it's just sad we don't have a cool story to go with it.
Yeah. Yeah, no. You know, it's funny how names work intergenerationally. Like I mentioned catching up with my mates and my old mates, uni mates last night. I've got so many mates who are called Dave.
Yeah, I
feel
like...
Dave Stokes, Dave Joyner, Dave Krantz, Dave Sack. Like,
your age
it just
group.
Goes on and on. It's like every bloke who was born in 1969 was called Dave.
I have two Uncle Davids.
Yeah. Well, they're probably the same age as me.
Yeah, roughly, yep.
50s?
Sure. Not entirely sure, but yes. Meat Tray Friday. Whatever. As well as Meat Tray Friday, we are heading over to the UK after 7 o'clock. It is Flashback Friday with Michael Smith. And we are announcing a 5AA Golf Day winner recipient. All that and more. It is 6:15. Back after this.
Introducing Nissan Future Value Business Plus, a new fleet finance solution for small to medium businesses offering competitive weekly repayments, including the cost of scheduled servicing for the loan term. Available now on the Nissan Navara SL 4x4 Dual Cab Auto. Plan confidently for the road ahead with Nissan Future Value Business Plus. Visit nissan.com.au/businessplus or contact your local Nissan dealer. Approved ABN registered small to medium fleet applicants of Nissan Financial Services. T's and C's and exclusions apply.
Thomas and Friends All Engines Go storybooks have arrived, exclusive to Drake's Supermarkets. Collect the whole set of 10 books, then pick up the collector's tin to store your complete collection for only $15. Simply purchase a specially marked product in an eligible transaction over $30 to get your free Thomas and Friends All Engines Go storybook and start collecting your set today. Drake's, ingredients for every day.
Want to get out of the office for the big board meeting, hosting a huge celebration, or intimate cocktails? The Lakes Hotel has a function space for every occasion. The menu is stunning, with nibbles, canapes, refreshments and feasts, and the lakes views are spectacular. If you're in for a big night, every booking offers discounted accommodation. Just pop upstairs and relax in the comfortable modern rooms. Next time you're hosting, let the Lakes Hotel West Lakes look after it all. Search the Lakes Hotel for details.
They're clever little things. They detect over 50 objects a second, have 2 million moving parts, and they clean themselves 20 times a minute. But even though they're the quickest muscles in our body, we're sometimes a little slow to look after them. Give your eyes the health check they deserve at Optical by National Pharmacies. And if you remember, you can save $100 on prescription lenses too. Book an eye test today. Conditions apply. Offer ends November 30.
This weekend, join the nation's leading journalists in the Weekend Australian. Andrew McMillan interviews the talented multi-instrumentalist Jacob Collier prior to his December tour. And what does the future hold for Australia this decade? Bernard Salt investigates. Tomorrow in the Weekend Australian.
Race into Tyre Power and take pole position during the Great Race Sale. The crew from Tyre Power is giving you the power to buy three and get one free on selected Kumho tyres. Put your pedal to the metal and visit tyrepower.com.au or call 13 21 91 during Tyre Power's Great Race Sale.
Kate Collins and Brenton Radless, the faces you know and the team you can trust. Nine News, made in Adelaide for Adelaide.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings, 5AA Breakfast.
Good morning to you. Let's have a look at the news this morning. We are going to head to the UK after 7 o'clock. But of course, British Prime Minister Liz Truss has resigned one day after telling Parliament that she's a fighter, not a quitter.
What was the term we used? In more trouble than the early settlers to Liz Truss the other day. That was an understatement.
She's the shortest serving British Prime Minister by a long shot. And I could tell you exactly, because the one after her, the next shortest was 119 days. And that was a guy by the name of George Canning from in 1827. And he only resigned because he passed away.
Yeah, right.
So 45 days.
It actually
took
someone's death.
Yes.
To eclipse her by almost threefold. Our shortest was Black Jack McEwen in, 1966, when, from memory, he was the leader of the National Party, Deputy PM. He became PM. Again, it was a death that necessitated that. He became Prime Minister after the disappearance of Harold Holt, but then there was a general election. And from memory, it was John Gorton, the Liberal, who was elected Prime Minister then.
There you go.
In the 60s. Poor old Harold Holt. Whatever happened to Harold Holt?
We'll never know. Well, poor old Liz Truss. We know exactly what happened to her. She got driven out by her own party. Now it's
she's in more trouble than Harold Holt.
There will be election as early as Monday, I believe, and Boris Johnson can be up for contention.
So the difference this time is they had a general ballot for all Tory party members to resolve the leadership once Johnson was ousted or knew that the writing was on the wall and left. So that's why it took such a long time. For the good of the party, but more importantly for national stability, Truss has said she'll go within a week, which means it's a party room decision. It's the MPs who decide. You'd think Richie Sunak, the bloke who was the Chancellor under Johnson, who was the guy who came second, despite being the public choice for the leadership, you'd think he's a Monty to win it.
You'd think. But we'll get Vincent's tip after 7:05.
Just an amazing story. Just so, what does that woman do with the rest of her life, though? Like, what do you write on your CV?
45 days as PM. Yeah. Precisely that.
Is she going to write her memoirs?
You can't lie about that.
Yeah, yeah.
SA retailers have welcomed extended trading hours. Some stores will be able to open from 9 a.m. instead of 11 a.m. on Sunday mornings, and suburban retailers will be allowed to trade on Boxing Day. Roger Drake from, of course, Drake Supermarket says it's a good outcome.
Our customers told us that Sunday 11 o'clock, and our staff said 11 o'clock. You've messed up the whole day anyway. What's the difference?
A new report by the Heart Foundation reveals one in two Australians are not confident cooking with legumes. We are being encouraged to try and find ways to introduce them into our diet, such as adding beans to tacos or lentils to bolognese.
Legumes are easy.
This is your wheelhouse, David.
You'd like a legume, wouldn't you, Lise?
I do, yes. And this Heart Foundation senior dietitian agrees with you. She says there's many benefits to adding them into our diet.
Legumes keep us fuller for longer. They have slow-release carbohydrates as well as really being rich in protein and dietary fibre. So it's these three key components that are good for our heart. They'll actually help to lower your cholesterol if you eat more legumes.
Lentils, brown lentils, peas, feta.
Chickpeas?
No, this is an excellent salad.
It's a recipe.
Brown lentils, peas, mint, feta, parsley, red onion. Pea, feta, mint and lentil salad is an excellent salad. It takes about 2 minutes to make it. You can use tinned lentils. Tastes better if you use home-cooked lentils. Lentils only take about half an hour to cook.
While I'm in charge here, every recipe that you mention, you now need to bring in for us to taste test.
All right, I'll make it. I'll bring some in on Monday. I can make it Sunday, and it's really good with grilled meats.
I mean,
it's a good barbecue salad. And what about your old four-bean mix? That's a classic Australian salad. It's so smashable. I can eat a whole plate of that. But if you make that, then you have leftovers, particularly if you put a fair amount of nice, fresh green celery in it. Just chuck a can of tuna in it for the next day and you've got your lunch sorted out.
Health. Look at us.
Or a hard-boiled egg.
The healthy 5AA breakfast show.
For your protein. It's good. It's good stuff.
Looking at the weather for today, 23, partly cloudy. Tomorrow we're in for 21 with a shower or two, up to 3 mils. Now, Sunday was the real question around rainfall. It has dropped, thankfully, top of 18. But instead of up to 15 mils, only up to 6 mils, if you will. Monday, 18, and possible shower.
Getting some good texts here. Baby names, why you are named what you're named, or why you named your kids what they're named. Rob says, I'm not named after anyone, but my initials are RL. And all three of my children have snuck their RL combination into their name somewhere. That's good. I like this one. My mate Shane thought that he was named after the famous Western movie, but he later found out that the neighbours had a dog called Shane, and that's from where his mum drew the inspiration.
There you go. Remember, you do have to call to be part of the meat tray, 8223 0000. The boys are out there ready to take your calls. But we have Tom Rann in for sport. Tom. As I find the old credit sheet once again.
That old chestnut,
10-year warranty and 10-year cap price servicing at Agostino, Mitsubishi, Nailsworth and Elizabeth Rennie.
Hello, Lucy.
I'm guessing, Tom, you were named after Tom Selleck from...
Exactly, Magnum P.I.
Magnum P.I.
Three men and a baby.
How's the mo coming along?
Not well, and either's the height, unfortunately, you Lucy, know, but I'm working on it.
You know, in Italian, Magnum P.I., PI stands for Perito Industriale, which means industrial engineer.
Oh, really?
Doesn't have quite the same resonance, does it?
It doesn't.
Magnum, industrial engineer. That building Tom looks Selleck. Poorly designed.
Now, I know you were talking about the time of Will's baby. I've got a bit of more info, a bit more meat on the bone.
You did a multi, didn't you, mate?
Well, no, really? I've got some info on it if you
this
want.
This is exclusive news,
yeah,
Tom.
Yeah, so I get along pretty well with his brother, so I've just texted his brother, and he's a barista just down the road. Oh, I said, right. What time did Wilbur have little Rosie, or I should say Alison have little Rosie, and he said around 2 p.m., maybe earlier. Got the message 2:20. So I think it might be in the 1:30 to 2 o'clock region.
Okay. So
it's going to require a bit of maths.
Is it ever?
Yeah, because...
Pushing it into the Greg from West Croydon.
Yeah, Greg in West Croydon was 11:45. Jane in Edwardstown was 4:17.
I reckon it. Oh, yeah. I don't want to call it, but maybe Greg. But I hate that. I don't have an exact time for
that's
you.
Right.
I'm sorry.
We'll wait for Will to announce it, and we'll do some maths in the meantime. What have you got in sport, Rennie?
Well, today I'm really looking forward to this clash for the Crows, Lucy. It kind of feels like a bit of a season-defining one. The Crows without Chelsea Randall, who's had an outstanding season.
Is she gone for the season?
Well, not the season, 3 to 5 weeks, but it makes it mighty close. I think she'll come back for the finals, but whether she's 100% fit. But they're going to certainly be missing her.
Are they going to make the finals?
Yeah, they're fourth at the moment, and that's why tonight's game's so big, because they're playing Geelong, who are fifth. Got to finish in the top four, you know, to have that double chance.
Yeah.
No Randall, though. At Unley, got to bounce back after a loss to Brisbane last week. So huge game for the Crows without, you know, arguably their best player this season. They've had some great players, Marinoff again, Hatchard. Allen's been good, but, you know, without Chelsea Randall, who's been exceptional this season, they're going to have to find a way. Magic round, a few more details. It's looking increasingly like South Australia's in the mix. I mean, you spoke to the Premier earlier in the week.
He seems pretty confident.
Yeah, I'd love to see it happen. It looks like, you know what, I love the fact that we're going after things like Live and Magic round. Let's go for it. I think we need to be pushing hard as a state for stuff like that. So we'll wait to hear, but that news should come through, you know, reasonably soon as well. And Ross Lyon, we spoke about that yesterday, should be announced as soon as today. So that's a mere formality. He's had all the meetings. He's met with them 3 times. So expect that to be ratified and signed off and announced, I would think, today.
How many St Kilda fans do you reckon are in Adelaide?
Do
we have a big Saints fan base here?
There's a few.
My cousin is married to a mad Saints fan.
The late Greg Kilton was such a massive Saints fan.
Yeah.
That the tragic moment he died after his death, he was buried with a Saints flag his coffin. Yeah.
Yeah. Not many loose, but
Saints scarf.
But they're a passionate supporter base.
Passionate and long suffering.
And long, exactly. I was about to say, and if they're with St Kilda, they've been loyal because there's not been much to cheer about for the last 120 years.
Right. Warney was a Saints fan.
And Molly Meldrum.
Eric Banner.
Yep, Eric Banner, Molly Meldrum.
Here, no money.
Yeah.
Remember that from Chopper?
Yes, that's
Vince
right.
Vince Colosimo, he's in a bit of strife.
Well, save that for another day. Yes, thank you, Rennie.
Thanks, guys. Great job.
Good luck to the Crows. Back after 6:30 news.
IGA's price match promise. We checked, we matched, you won't pay more. Every week we check and match the regular price of the big two supermarkets on hundreds of everyday products. Just look out for the price match tickets in store. Participating stores only. See website for full terms.
For over 38 years, Steinbrenner has been well worth the trip. With over 400 used cars to choose from, you're sure to find the car you're looking for. Steinbrenner is your first choice for new Hyundai and Mitsubishi in the Barossa, and your first choice for Ford in Clare. And don't forget, you can always click through the collection of vehicles online at steinbrenner.com.au. Great local deals on great local cars from your locals. Steinbrenner Automotive. Still well worth the trip or well worth the click.
Adelaide is coming up roses. Be surrounded by thousands of stunning roses at the Adelaide International Rose and Garden Expo. Enjoy spectacular rose blooms, floral and plant displays, expert gardening advice, garden products galore, free activities for the kids and more. Gather your fellow garden lovers for the Adelaide International Rose and Garden Expo. Adelaide Convention Centre, October 28 to 30. Tickets are $20 with children under 14 free. Book at roseexpo.au. That's roseexpo.au.
Wednesdays are special days at Wallace Cinemas. Every Wednesday is Seniors Day. That means free morning tea or coffee before you see a movie. It's your choice of movies from Bobby's Classics. It's new release movies. It's the big screen and stunning Quake sound. It's homemade Choc Tops with Golden North ice cream, fruit chocs and freshly popped popcorn. For a great day out, make Wallace Cinema's Wednesday Seniors Days a regular event on your calendar. Visit wallace.com.au or download the app for session times.
Hello, Frank Walker from National Tiles. National Tiles 5,000 plus trade club members shop the very best trade brands online 24/7 and our 35 National Tiles stores across Australia. Yes, National Tiles 5,000 plus trade club members shop the very best trade brands online 24/7 and at our 35 National Tiles stores across Australia. So tradies, sign up today to National Tiles for exclusive trade club offers every day of the year.
5AA Breakfast is streaming live right now. To watch, simply head online to 5AA Facebook or search 5AA on YouTube.
This is Adelaide's 5AA.
Partly cloudy and 23 today with the 6:30 news. I'm Mel Usher. The UK opposition wants a general election to appoint Britain's next Prime Minister. Liz Truss has resigned after just 45 days in office, making her the shortest-serving leader in the country's history. A new PM will be announced next week. Labour leader Sir Keir Starmer says it's chaos.
What a mess. And this is not just a soap opera at the top of the Tory party. It's doing huge damage to our economy and to the reputation of our country.
We're officially paying more for rent than our neighbours in Melbourne. The average weekly rent in the southern suburbs, places like Seaford Rise and Flagstaff Hill, is up $120 to around $500 a week, while the median rent in Melbourne is $430. Scammers are targeting flood-affected residents in Melbourne's northwest. Stan lives near the Maribyrnong River. He hasn't been able to apply for flood relief payments because someone else has already made several applications using his address.
If people are having trouble applying, it's because there's scammers out there trying to rip the system. It just numbs you, you know, because you don't know. It sort of muddles your head.
It's an anxious wait for Medibank customers to see if their personal medical information will be leaked following the cyber attack. The personal records could be made public as the insurer is held to ransom, with concerns individuals will become the target of blackmailers. Medibank is working with federal police. And a set of governance principles on cybersecurity has been released to help companies protect their data in the wake of these recent breaches. The guides provide a framework across five key areas, including incorporating cyber into risk management. The Australian Institute of Company Directors Chief Executive Mark Rigotti says the guides will help minimise cyber threats.
What they're trying to do is to bring forward some practical things that boards of companies can do to meet the cyber security threat. And really sort of just put down some red flags to identify where things might not be quite right.
A new report by the Heart Foundation reveals one in two Aussies are not confident cooking with legumes. We're being encouraged to try new ways to introduce them into our diet, such as adding beans to tacos or lentils to a bolognese. Heart Foundation senior dietitian Anne O'Hanlon says there are many benefits to adding them to our diet.
Legumes keep us fuller for longer. They have slow-release carbohydrates as well as really being rich in protein and dietary fibre. So it's three key components that are good for our heart. They'll actually help to lower your cholesterol if you eat more legumes.
For the first time, scientists have uncovered the remains of a closely related Neanderthal clan. They were discovered in the mountains of southern Siberia and are believed to have perished together around 54,000 years ago. Now turning to 5AA Sport.
All new 2022 Mitsubishi Outlander with 10-year warranty, 10 years capped price servicing at Agostino Mitsubishi.
It's over to Tom Wren.
Thank you, Mel. South Australia will play against Tasmania today in a one-dayer, hoping to bounce back after a disappointing Shield loss against the Tigers. The Redbacks are 1-1 in the one-day competition. Still on cricket, and Sri Lanka and the Netherlands have qualified for the Super 12 stage at the T20 World Cup, the Sri Lankans securing their place with a 16-run win over the Dutch. To soccer, and a big blow for the Socceroos with Aiden Hrustic in a race against time to be fit for the World Cup in Qatar. That's after his Italian Serie A club, Hellas Verona, confirmed he has an ankle injury. Meantime, in the English Premier League, Fulham is leading Aston Villa 2-0 with about 15 minutes to play. The opening goal coming in the 36th minute.
Pushed away by Martinez, but here's Reed. Lined out, finds the net. Brilliant finish from Harrison Reed. A deserved lead for Fulham.
Audio there thanks to Optus. Leicester also has a 2-0 lead over Leeds right now on half-time. Whilst in the Europa League, Arsenal has guaranteed its progression into the knockout stages after a 1-0 win against PSV Eindhoven. And in some baseball news, the New York Yankees and the Houston Astros will go head-to-head this morning in Game 2 of the American League Championship Series. The Astros won Game 1 of the best-of-seven series yesterday with a 4-2 win. In the National League Championship Series, the San Diego Padres have levelled their series against Philadelphia at 1-1 after coming from behind to beat the Phillies 8-5. And that's the 5AA Sport.
Now the 5AA forecast, partly cloudy, a top of 23 today, a shower or two tomorrow, 21, Sunday a shower or two, 18. Right now it's 17 degrees. More news as it happens on 5AA.
Ladies, is the need to we all the time making your life a misery? Caruso's Wee Less to the rescue. Caruso's Wee Less relieves the annoying and inconvenient feeling that you need to go to the bathroom too often and supports bladder health and function. So if your need to wee all the time is getting in the way of enjoying life, try Caruso's Wee Less today. Caruso's Wee Less is made in Australia, comes with a money-back guarantee, and is available from leading pharmacies and health food stores. Always read the label and follow the directions for use.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings, 5AA Breakfast.
Good morning to you. We're in for 23, partly cloudy today, David. Happy Friday to you.
Happy Friday too, Liz.
Of course it is.
And to all of our listeners.
And to all of our listeners, it is Meat Tray Friday. Thanks to Dane and the team at Blackwood Country Meats, 248 Main Road in Blackwood. We've taken our inspiration from Will's darling new daughter, Rosie May.
Rosie Goodings. May.
Rosie May.
Rosie May. I was Rosie thinking, May. Finish this sentence, Rosie May. Rosie May become Prime Minister.
Well, she may become the UK Prime Minister. There is a job going.
There's a vacancy, of course.
So we want to hear from you. Who are you named after, or you've named your kids after someone? It could be someone famous, could just be a relative. If you've got a story about who you're named after, and we've got Rosemary on the line. Morning, Rosemary.
Good morning, David and Lucy. And Lucy, congratulations on your rise, because you'll become a rise to fame. The effort you put into your job is absolutely magnificent, and to come up with Rosie was brilliant.
thank you, Rosemary.
From one Rosie to another.
From one Rosie to another. What's your story, Rosemary? Thank you for your compliments.
Well, I was named. I used to hate my name growing up because no one. I never knew any Rosemarys. There was no Joy's Bay. My brothers were Jeff and Peter. And I had Rosemary, and it got to me. And when I was about 19, I said to my dad, "Did you really hate me when I was born?" And I said, "Why?" And he said, "Why?" And I said, "Well, why would you call me Rosemary? No one's called Rosemary." And he said, "We named you after Rosemary Clooney. And I
George's auntie, wasn't she?
Yes, she was. And I thought,
she sang Mambo Italiano.
Yes, yeah, and. Then I thought, oh, well, I'm better than my brothers. I've named after someone special.
And a very good-looking woman too, Rosemary Clooney.
Yes, yes.
Beautiful eyes.
But I now go to a sewing group and there's three Rosemarys in the class. Well, and it's
a lovely name, Rosemary.
I was so tickled pink that they named me after someone special.
Absolutely.
Hey, that's great.
Thanks for your call, Rosemary.
Good on you, Rosemary.
Get calling 8223 0000 for the meat tray this morning. Now, we had a text from Stephen yesterday about snakes. It is snake
three
season.
Three red-bellied blacks that he'd seen.
Yeah, now Stephen's based up in the Adelaide Hills, so we thought, you know what, start of snake season, it's nearly a tradition actually to chat about brown snakes and their prominence, especially in South Australia. We've got Rolly Burrell on the line from Snake Catchers Adelaide. Morning, Rolly.
Good morning, how are you?
Good, thank you. How are you today? It is International Snake Day, fun fact.
Yeah, well, I'm sitting in my car with a cup of coffee ready to go.
Are you on a job already, Roller? Have you got your long stick ready to go, mate?
No, I don't use sticks, mate. I'm a professional.
Rolly, I was going to ask, you guys have a 24-hour helpline. How many middle-of-the-night calls have you had?
The calls at night. Pathetic, really. They're just people setting you up all the time.
Oh, really? What, like
yeah,
prank calls?
Yeah, no, they just ring you up 3 in the morning just to wake you up, and it's just a load of rubbish. I don't know if they're on something or
seriously?
Whatever, but seriously, we get it all the time. I'll turn my phone off now, so I feel sorry for the people that are going to have a snake in their house, but that's the way it goes.
Prank calling a snake catcher, I've not once ever had that thought cross my mind, never.
Oh, they say something like, oh, my wife's being chased around the room with an anaconda, you know, and I won't go on.
All right, well, Rolly, tell us about the snakes
There's a Barry McKenzie song about that, I think.
Yeah, I'm sure there is.
All right, well, we clearly don't have anacondas here, but we've got the king browns, we've got red-bellied black snakes. What do we see the most of usually in October, Rolly?
Well, king browns don't hang around suburbia. They're more up Hawkeway and Port Augusta, so we don't get king browns in South Australia. In Adelaide. So you're really dealing with red-bellied blacks, tiger snakes, and the eastern brown snake.
What's the worst one? When you're going toe to toe, not that snakes have got toes, but when you're going head to head with a snake, Rolly, what's the one you treat with the most caution?
Maybe the tiger snake.
Yeah.
The tiger snake is it's a little bit more fragile, and when you grab it by the tail, you definitely know that you're onto a tiger.
They're really aggro, are they?
Yeah, they are. They are, and they're not flexible like the eastern brown and the red-bellied black. Like, the red-bellied black's quite a placid snake.
I saw in the news cycle from, I think, maybe Queensland this week, Rolly, there was a blue-bellied black snake. Do we get them anywhere near here?
No, but they're in the same family as the collared snake, the red-bellied black, and then you've got the blue-bellied. They're all the same genus.
I'm sorry to ask you this, Rolly, because it's probably about the millionth time you've been asked this question, but how many times have you been bitten?
Well, mate, if you saw me, you'd think I was mummified.
So many.
No, lots and lots of times, and it's just one of those things. Sometimes you're in a bird aviary and you've got branches everywhere, and you've got the snake, and the lady's shutting the door so the birds don't come out, and so you can't come out, so usually you get done.
Yeah, right.
God, trapped in a bird aviary with a snake sounds my idea of a nightmare. I was going to ask as well, Rolly, I've seen a few long grasses along sort of curbs and nature strips in some council areas. How many of them have you had to get just from like an overgrown set of weeds on the curb?
Look, snakes go anywhere today. It doesn't matter if you've got short grass, long grass, you know, they've adapted. And we're a messy race of people. We leave scraps everywhere and food everywhere, so that brings on the mice and the rats, and that brings in the snakes. But, you know, snakes aren't here to hurt us at all.
Mm. No, they're not,
are they? They're terrified of us. I've never had a snake jump in a bag yet. they're terrified of us, and you can't blame them. You know, like, everything we do, we sort of interfere with everything and destroy everything, so...
Totally agree.
Just part of South Australian life.
They are actually beautiful animals, aren't they, Rolly? Like, I reckon the red-bellied black is such a nice snake.
It is. It is. And, you know, if you leave them alone and you've got a healthy respect, all they're doing in your garden is, I mean, sure, if you've got cats and dogs, you've got to get them removed. But they're only in there getting rid of the rats, mice. They get rid of feral cats out in the bush. They're not a bad thing to have around. I mean, you've got to understand them, but I prefer to work with snakes any day than I would humans.
That says it all. Thank you so much, Rolly, for your time. Good luck this snake season.
All right, thank you, bye.
Thank you, bye.
Good on you, Rolly. Talking to Rolly.
Snakes.
He's a character.
Watch out, wear long socks, stand back, stamp your feet so it causes vibration.
I remember reading an excellent article in the NT News, which is the world's best newspaper, about a guy...
Also who... very reliable.
Oh, yeah, that's right. But this bloke had caught a snake and he put it in a bag and he was off his face and he was drink driving and he kept trying to hold the snake down in the bag. He ended up getting bitten like 77 times by the same snake. And
did he live to tell the tale?
He did, and he told the tale to the NT News and they splashed with it, obviously. But it seems like you've got to try pretty hard to get bitten by a snake.
I think so.
Have you ever seen one in real life?
Yeah, on my walk the other day.
Oh, of course, you said
that I talked about yesterday. I actually stood on one up at my parents' farmhouse again about October, I think it was, and it was on the front door mat, and I thought it was the cat's tail, but I looked over to my left, and about 10 metres away was my cat, and I looked down, and it was a brown snake, and my friend, who thankfully was behind me, just yanked me right back inside the door and slammed the door.
Yeah, right.
And another 4-foot brown snake just dopily slid off.
We saw a little baby brown snake, would have been probably... 50 centimetres long, on the top of the wooden steps at the Silver Sands stairs in the sand dunes at Aldinga. We were just walking down to the beach, not far from the Surf Life Saving Club, and I looked at it and thought, that's not a stick.
Nope.
I was with the kids, and I went, it's a snake! But it took off like a tracer bullet.
Yeah, they're bloody fast.
Yeah, incredible.
Bob in Cheltenham, you've called in on snakes. Good morning.
Good morning, guys. In regards to, I just turned the radio on just as you were talking with your guest and brought back the memory of having a death adder sleep with me when I was on army exercise up at Coltana, just outside of Port Augusta, and having had a childhood fear of snakes, a matter of years later, I've got one sleeping with me, and it really, really shook me up.
They're quite fat-looking snakes, aren't they, Bob, death adders?
It is. They're a short-bodied snake, but fat. But the actual head is so triangular.
Yeah, yeah, and they're crazy-looking things.
Yeah, the imprint in bull dust of this thing sleeping under me, and I thought it was in the bag with me, my sleeping bag, and I thought if I move, I'm gone. And the gear up, you know, the species up there, they're deadly. You know, they're not garden python variety.
No. Wow.
Sounds like something you don't want to sleep with.
Quite a night's sleep. Good on you, Bob. Thanks for your call, mate.
Thanks, Bob. Let's check traffic for the first time this morning with summer just around the corner. Beat the rush. Get your air conditioning sorted now with Mannix.
Thanks, Lucy, and good morning. At Modbury, you want a crash this morning, Northeast Road near Kelly Road. Got a lane out of action at CV Downs. That's outbound on Majors Road near Ocean Boulevard. Speed's currently down to 40 km. Anti-slow going for works at Brighton. Brighton Road near Edward Street. Speed's down to 40. Got a few cameras around today. Don't let them ruin your weekend. You'll find them on Grey Terrace, Rosewater, and Andrews Road at Andrews Farm. It's all about the seasoning. GYG's uniquely addictive chipotle seasoning really sets their fries apart. Grab them at your local GYG today. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Everyday low prices, any time of year. Trust the mighty South Aussies. Great food lives here. Foodland.
You're watching the 5AA live stream, thanks to Foodland.
The mighty South Aussies, yeah.
It's that new car experience, and you'll still be feeling it long after you drive away in a new Hilux from Jarvis Toyota. The tough new Hilux features an upgraded 2.8-litre diesel, delivering 20 kilowatts more power. The Hilux is packed full of Toyota Safety Sense intelligent technology. Apple CarPlay and Android Auto as standard, plus 3-year cap price servicing. Rediscover the road in the all-new Toyota Hilux at Jarvis Toyota. South Road, Clovelly Park, proudly celebrating 21 years of great deals.
Bonus local delivery on selected Australian-made mattresses at Harvey Norman. Spend over $999. King Coil by AH Beard, Sleepmaker and CB Posturepedic. Plus 60 months interest-free, no deposit finance from Latitude with 60 approximately equal monthly payments and receive a bonus gift card up to $1,000. Finance only available if you have or are approved for a participating Latitude credit card. Minimum financed amount $1,000. See T's and C's. Interest applies for non-compliance. Fees and product exclusions apply. In-store purchases only. Bonus local delivery on selected Australian-made mattresses at Harvey Norman. Go!
Brick, block, pave and save. Stack, lay, pattern and play. The look, the quality, the range.
Luton!
Right now, you can save up to 25% off quality Luton, formerly Boral Masonry. Bricks, blocks and pavers at your local Luton reseller.
The range. Luton. The look, the quality, the range.
Save up to 25% off at your Luton reseller today.
G'day, what you looking at?
Shh.
Be quiet. Oh, what you looking at?
Oh, well, isn't it obvious? It's remarkable. The detail and finish of Michelangelo with the raw beauty of Monet. I've never seen anything like it.
I have. I've got one at home, driving it every day.
What? What do you mean? That's ridiculous.
It's an exposed aggregate driveway. Beautiful.
Right, who's the artist?
Adelaide Exposed Concrete. Best on ground all year round.
Kate Collins and Brenton Radless. The faces you know and the team you can trust. Nine News, made in Adelaide for Adelaide. David Penberthy and Will Griggs, 5AA Breakfast.
Good morning to you on this Friday. Top of 23 today. We've got Jenny Horvath this morning from the Bureau of Meteorology. Morning, Jenny.
Good morning, Lucy. Good morning, David.
How are we looking, Jenny? It's been a beautiful couple of days and it feels like it's going to continue looking out the window over Hindmarsh Square. Looks like another lovely one.
Yeah, look, it's going to be a pretty good start. A little bit of cloud coming through. So we've still got that low pressure system dominating our weather. It's now over New South Wales. It's making its way south into Victoria. As it heads south, we're going to pick up a bit of moisture as it wraps around from the south. So I couldn't rule out a little bit of shower activity later today. We're not expecting too much. So out on the golf course this afternoon at Wollunga, I believe, I couldn't rule out a shower. So maybe take that golf umbrella for the odd sprinkle that might happen this afternoon.
David's friend, of course.
Yeah, of course, we'll be diligently working for the newspapers for tomorrow. But, that's our little secret, Jenny.
Yes. And with that low pressure system, it's a little bit unstable. So a little bit of thunderstorm activity again, not out of the question. Probably more likely in the hills and in the north. But we'll see how we go with that. This system is sort of weakening, but still we're keeping a little bit of an eye on it. It's been a little bit of a warmer start this morning. Minimum temperature of 16 degrees at 3 a.m. And currently 16.9 at our West Terrace Night Apira observation site. We are aiming for 23 degrees in the city and the north. Northern suburbs, 22 along the coast and 23 up at Mount Barker. So we've got another system coming across from the west on Saturday and a cold front clipping the south for the weekend. So it looks like we'll see some cooler temperatures returning and maybe more chance to see a little bit of shower activity again. We're not expecting too much, but we couldn't rule out a shower or two coming through on Saturday. Temperature of around 21 degrees after a minimum of 12. Shower or two again possible on Sunday. Look, we will go southeasterly, so for the city maybe not too much in there, but on the eastern side and the hills we could pick up a little bit more. But that temperature coming back down to around 18 degrees on Sunday following that change. I'm going to stay in that cooler southerly airstream as we start next week. So possible shower on Monday and Tuesday around 18 degrees and getting up to around 20 degrees by Wednesday on Thursday there, guys.
Beautiful stuff.
Excellent.
Jenny. Thanks,
Jenny.
Thank you.
Head to police now. Kimberly Broad, good morning to you.
Morning, Lucy. Morning, Dave.
What are we starting with? A fatal hit-run crash at Murray Bridge East, Kimberley.
Yeah, that was about 9:45 last night. We had police and emergency services called to the Old Princes Highway after reports a woman had been hit by a car and that vehicle failed to stop after the collision. And sadly, a 40-year-old woman from Murray Bridge died at the scene. The Old Princes Highway was closed for several hours while we had our major crash investigators up at the scene, but was reopened just before 3:30 this morning. The woman's death is the 58th life lost on SE roads this year compared to 79 at the same time last year. Those investigations are continuing to locate the vehicle involved. And we've got major crash investigators urging anyone who witnessed the crash and hasn't yet spoken with police or was perhaps driving in that area at that time, 9:45 last night, who possibly has some dash cam footage, if they could please contact Crime Stoppers on 1-800-333-000.
Kimberly, also a man's been arrested in a stolen car in the northern suburbs.
Yeah, we saw, it was about 8:30 last night, we spotted a stolen grey Volkswagen Tiguan on Lincoln Crescent at Paraka. Now, that vehicle immediately took off and was lost sight of. It had been stolen during a break-in at Campbelltown early Sunday morning. But we had Polair go up and assist with a search of the area. Picked it up again about just before 9 o'clock last night in Paraka. And it was tracked from the air as it headed south on Main North Road through the back streets out into the northwestern suburbs and continued out into the northern suburbs where it eventually, the driver abandoned the car on Kings Road at Paralowie. Now, the driver fled but was quickly arrested by patrols in the backyard of a nearby home. So we've got a 35-year-old man of no fixed address. He's been arrested and charged with illegal use of a motor vehicle, dangerous driving to escape police pursuit and several other matters, but he didn't apply for bail, so he'll be appearing in court today.
Good stuff, Kimberly. Thank you for that and have a great weekend.
Thank you. You too.
Thanks, Kimberly. Now for the meat tray this morning, we are asking, what are you named after or someone you know, if it's a celebrity, a relative, whoever you like. Jill in Hackman West, good morning.
Oh, good morning, guys. I love your show.
Thanks,
and
Jill.
Congratulations to all the Goodings family. Look, my son-in-law is a mad Manchester United fan, so their firstborn son was named after David Beckham. Now, David, it's not the David bit, it's the Beckham bit.
So they called him Beckham?
Yeah, his name is Beckham.
His name is Beckham.
That's a pretty cool first name.
Is Beckham.
Yeah. Wow.
That's cool.
Does he get called Bex?
His parents called him Bex. I always called him Beckham, but his parents, mum and dad, called him Bex from time to time. Yeah.
That's awesome. What a name.
Well, not strange, but a bit unusual. I thought David was going to be, and this is no insult to you, David, but I thought that was a bit plain, but I never imagined it was going to be the Beckham bit. So,
not insulting at all, Jill. It's as plain as it gets. But Beckham's certainly not plain. It's
Thank
exotic.
You, Jill. That's a good one. Excellent. Thanks, Jill. Chris in Royston Park, good morning.
Good morning, everyone. I was born in 1964, and my grandfather always told me that I was named after Christine Keeler.
Christine Keeler from the Profumo Affair.
Yeah, who brought down the British government.
That's right.
I wasn't quite sure.
Harold Macmillan's
government. Many years before I worked out whether he thought I was model quality or if I was just trouble.
Can I ask, without wanting to pry too much, Christine, have you ever posed sitting on a chair?
No.
You know the famous photograph I'm referring to?
Yes, I do. Yes.
It's a very sexy photograph.
I think I was a teenager before I actually researched it. Yeah.
There's still time, Chris, don't worry. Plenty of time for chair photos.
It's a famous photo. It's just of Christine Keeler. She's naked.
There you go.
But she's sitting on one of those excellent sort of plastic-backed sort of 60s chairs. Like, it's extruded. So it's hard plastic. You can't see through it.
Mm.
But she's just sitting there, starkers, with a long, curved, sort of bobbed hair. I think... who's the famous royal photographer? Was it Lord Snowden who took all the... was the photographer who was married Princess Margaret?
We'll
but
get
he's
our,
a total
get our Google
pants
team
man.
On.
I think he took that photograph. But it's an iconic photograph from the 1960s.
Alan and Jepps Cross, good morning. You've got a name?
Yes. My name is spelled A-L-L-A-N, but when I was born 77 years ago, the father registered me wrong. The person I named after was named after was Dad played the Sambo band for about 60-odd years, and Alan was the bandmaster of Bowden back in 1945 when I was born. I found out 50 years later that poor old Dad registered my name wrong. I was asked to speak at and his daughter's stepfather's funeral, and I was checking out a little bit to get the eulogy right, and... with that, they laughed because they knew the story that I was named after their father. And their father's name was spelled actually A-L-L-E-N, and Dad registered me, as I said, as A-L-L-A-N.
Well, it clearly hasn't held you back in life, Alan. Good on you, mate.
Excellent, Alan.
We're getting a mountain of text as well. I really like this one because I remember the show way back in the 70s. It was an excellent program. Joe from Gawler says, morning, Dave and Lucy. My son is named Callum, after the show with Edward Woodward on the ABC. The show opened with a swinging light bulb. That's a terrific program. Edward Woodward, what a great actor. And, of course, the great joke, why does Edward Woodward's name have so many D's in it? Because if it didn't, he'd be called Edward Woodward. You ever heard that one?
No, but I'm a big fan.
That's good.
Automasters text line, please text us with who you were named after, 0448 083095, or give us a call to win the meat tray, 8223 00.
You must have a lot of moments, Lou, sitting here with me where your eyes just totally glaze over. Like when I start talking about programs like Callum or The Professionals, you must just go...
And that's just a generational gap in our in our discussion, David.
Well, we're going to learn a lot over the following 2 weeks, Liz, both of us.
That's right. I like this text as well on the Automasters text line. Rolly, keeping it real, our snake catcher buddy. It's the human snakes you have to watch out for.
Absolutely.
And don't forget, you can tune in this Friday on the Foodland Supermarket Facebook and YouTube live stream. Back after the 7 o'clock news.
Go Vita, your local health food shops. Over 30 years health and wellness experience and over 300 natural health practitioners specialising in you.
Hi, I'm Ali from Go Vita Marion and Colonnades, and you can find these specials at any Go Vita store. Merrow's Fish Oil Heart and Health is sourced from 100% sustainable wild-caught deep-sea fish. 500ml is now only $17.95. Save 28%.
Go Vita, Colonnades, Fairview Green, Marion, Mount Barker, Manopara, Semaphore and Tanunda.
Hey Strikers fans, Jason Gillespie here. Forget footy season, it's time for SA to turn blue and get behind your mighty Adelaide Strikers. That's right, tickets to all WBBL and BBL matches are now on sale. And to welcome back the best fans in the league, we're excited to offer early bird pricing for a limited time across all matches. Don't delay, visit adelaidestrikers.com.au today for links to purchase, and we can't wait to see you back in blue this summer.
Patience pays off, especially if you've been holding out for a great deal on a new Volkswagen. Mawson Lakes Volkswagen is now receiving truckloads of new Volkswagens. Yes, they're coming, and they're available at amazing prices. Remember Mawson Lakes Volkswagen for servicing too, with next day servicing and free loan cars. Get a great deal on Volkswagen now. Don't dilly-dally, dawdle or delay. Mawson Lakes Volkswagen, just a short drive from the city.
Ladies, do you feel like your entire day revolves around your bladder? Caruso's Weeless relieves the annoying and inconvenient feeling that you need to go to the bathroom too often and supports bladder health and function. So if you want to help control the urge and regain your bladder confidence, try Caruso's Weeless today.
Caruso's Weedless is made in Australia and comes with a money-back guarantee and is available from leading pharmacies and health food stores. Always read the label and follow the directions for use.
5AA Breakfast is streaming live right now. To watch, simply head online to 5AA Facebook or search 5AA on YouTube. Online, on DAB Digital Radio and on 1395 AM. Talking Adelaide. This is Adelaide's 5AA.
Partly cloudy and 23 today with the 7 o'clock news. I'm Mel Usher. There's been a fatal hit run. Senior Constable Kimberly Broad says it happened on the Old Princess Highway at Murray Bridge East around 9.45 last night.
Sadly, a 40-year-old woman from Murray Bridge died at the scene. The Old Princess Highway was closed for several hours while we had our major crash investigators up at the scene, but was reopened just before 3.30 this morning.
Investigations to locate the vehicle are continuing. The woman's death is the 58th life lost on SA roads this year, compared to 79 at this time last year. Liz Truss has quit as British Prime Minister. London correspondent Brett McLeod has more.
After one of the most tumultuous and the briefest prime ministership in British history, Ms Truss announced she's standing down. The chaos of her six-week reign saw the pound sink, mortgage rates jump, and yesterday, allegations of Tory MPs being bullied to vote for her in the House of Commons. She will stay on until Britain's third Prime Minister this year is voted in by Tory MPs and possibly members during the next week. Former Chancellor Rishi Sunak is considered the front-runner, but Boris Johnson has signalled he's aiming for a comeback.
SA retailers have welcomed extended trading hours. Stores will be open from 9 instead of 11 on Sunday mornings, and suburban retailers will be allowed to trade on Boxing Day. Roger Drake from Drake Supermarket says it's a good outcome.
Our customers told us that Sunday at 11 o'clock, and our staff said 11 o'clock, you've messed up the whole day anyway. What's the difference?
Federal Police and the Office of the Australian Information Commissioner are investigating Medibank's cyber attack. Hackers have accessed names, addresses and phone numbers, as well as the data about health conditions and medical procedures of customers. It follows the recent cyber attack on Optus, where millions of customers were impacted. Cybersecurity expert Nigel Fair admits it's concerning, given these companies should be well protected.
Because these organisations, they do generally invest in cybersecurity, but the risk management thinking and the practicing of incident response is still not there.
Just oil protesters in London have taken aim at Harrods. They've sprayed orange paint on the outside of the luxury department store in Knightsbridge. It's the group's 20th consecutive day of action in the capital as they protest the UK government's new oil and gas licences. Jailed Melbourne drug lord Tony Mockbell wants some fresh air. The underworld figure has reportedly launched legal action against the Victorian government and Barwon Prison. He claims his human rights are being breached because he's being deprived of at least 1 hour of fresh air every day. And the Powerball has jackpotted after no Div 1 winners last night. Next Thursday night, it will be worth $160 million. Now turning to 5AA Sport.
10-year warranty and 10-year capped price servicing at Agostino Mitsubishi, Nailsworth and Elizabeth.
Lots happening in the cricket, Tom Wren.
Yeah, there certainly is, isn't there, Mel? Australia has brought in Cameron Green to replace Josh Inglis in the T20 World Cup squad after he hurt his hand in a freak golf accident. Meantime, South Australia will play against Tasmania later today in a one-dayer. Meantime, Matt Renshaw has again put his name into test calculations following a brilliant unbeaten double 100 for Queensland against New South Wales. And he's told Wild World of Sports he's back to enjoying his cricket and the results are showing.
Yeah, I think that's the most important thing. Like, after a couple of years ago getting dropped from the Shield team, I was just worrying about trying to play and then enjoy my cricket. And that's the big one I've been trying to do. And that involves helping the team win.
A huge game for Adelaide's women tonight when they take on Geelong at Unley Oval. That one's going to be big. Meantime, Ross Lyon could be unveiled as St Kilda coach as soon as today. And Richmond has secured Judson Clark, Sam Banks and Tom Brown on two-year AFL contract extensions. Two games in the NBL overnight, with the Cairns Taipans getting over the Melbourne United 81-77, while the South East Melbourne Phoenix took care of New Zealand 99-77. And in the NBA, Josh Giddey's Oklahoma couldn't get it done, beaten 115-108, despite 14 points and 11 rebounds from the 20-year-old Aussie. Well, Manchester United has dropped Cristiano Ronaldo out of the squad for this weekend's Premier League clash against Chelsea after he put on a petulant display during his side's win against Tottenham. He refused to be subbed on late in the 2-0 win and then stormed up the tunnel with several minutes still to play. Meantime, in EPL action this morning, Fulham has just crushed Aston Villa 3-0, while Leicester leads Leeds 2-0 with about half an hour to play. And that's the 5AA Sport.
Now checking 5AA traffic.
At Safe Drives, looking out for a crash this morning. Griffiths Drive at Commercial Road. That intersection is currently blocked. Avoid it if you can on the way to work. Modbury got a crash northeast road near Kelly Road. And at CV Downs this morning, got a lane out of action. Majors Road near Ocean Boulevard. Slow going, two speeds down to 40Ks. Camera-wise, you'll find one today. Andrews Road, Andrews Farm. And look out for another one. Great Terrace at Rosewater. The King's Spring Sale is in its final days. Up to 50% off selected Australian design award-winning furniture. Hurry, visit the King Kizik showroom today. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
The 5AA forecast, partly cloudy, 23 today, a shower or two tomorrow, 21. Sunday, a shower or two, 18, and 18 again on Monday. Right now, it's 17 degrees. More news as it happens on 5AA.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings, 5AA Breakfast.
Six after seven, good morning to you. 23 degrees on the way today. Momentous day. It is day two of the David and Lucy show. Will has had his, Will's wife, I should say, has had their gorgeous little baby, Rosie May. Hopefully.
It's day two of the Lucy and Dave show and day two of the Rosie May show as well.
That's right. Well, hopefully we get to chat with Will a bit later on. We do have federal politics at 7:30, followed by flashback and, of course, Meet Tray Friday. We are asking you what you are named after. But, of course, probably the biggest story that's happened overnight, while nearly all of us were sleeping, except for you, David, you managed to watch the
entire thing.
I came into office at a time of great economic and international instability. We delivered on energy bills and on cutting national insurance. And we set out a vision for a low tax, high growth economy that would take advantage of the freedoms of Brexit. I recognise though, given the situation, I cannot deliver the mandate on which I was elected by the Conservative Party.
As I said earlier, I had a bit of a quiet night at the pub with some mates last night. I got home at about 10:30. I thought I'd just pop on Sky News UK to see if anything of note is occurring, given the chat we had only a couple of days ago with our excellent friend and London correspondent, Vincent McAvinny. And sure enough, Liz Truss had fallen on her sword. We crossed to London now to catch up with Vincent again. Mate, this is just an unprecedented humiliation, isn't it?
Oh, incredibly. I mean, congratulations to Will and his wife. By the time their baby is a week old, it might have lived through two British prime ministers and two British foreign home secretaries. I mean, that is the pace at which things are changing here. I mean, Liz Truss has done 44 days in Downing Street. It is remarkable. It is the shortest now prime ministership. The previous record holder, I think it was around 100 or so days, and he at least had the excuse of tuberculosis to get that record.
Yeah, Vincent, that was George Canning back in 1827.
George Canning, yeah, and Liz Truss just has incompetence to blame for hers. She signed her own exit, to be honest, with an economic plan that very quickly unraveled, which spooked the markets, which resulted in her sacking her chancellor, even though it was her entire pitch to the Conservative Party. And there really are tonight deep questions for how Britain chooses its prime ministers, particularly the fact that Liz Truss came into office and potentially next week another prime minister will come into the office based solely on the votes of around 160,000 paid-up Conservative Party members who are in a nation of 65 million people, disproportionately older, male, white, and wealthy. There are serious questions tonight about how constitutional and how democratic it is that we're about to go into this process once again in the same parliamentary term.
So is it going to be the party members who decide, as opposed to the parliamentarians in a party room vote?
Okay, let me take you through it step by step, because it's only been announced this evening and it is slightly complex. So scenario one, there are around 356 Conservative Party MPs currently, in our parliament, which it has them. So they basically will all vote on Monday to decide who are the candidates that put themselves forward. Those MPs will vote. Now, they have to get over 100 votes to go through to a second round. But if there are too many candidates running, and let's say Rishi Sunak is the only one that gets more than 100 votes, he will automatically become Prime Minister on Monday. If, though, there are fewer candidates running, and let's say three get more than 100 votes, they will then go to a second round, and the person who gets the least is knocked out, and then it's a head-to-head with two candidates. They'll have a hustings at some point next week. Then Conservative Party members will get to do an online vote, and the MPs will get to just do an indicative vote, so it won't mean anything, but they will just vote for whoever is their favourite, so that the members in the country of the party can see who has the most support in Parliament. And then by the Friday, I mean a week tomorrow, that vote will conclude and the Prime Minister will be decided then. So that is, you know, how quickly things are going to move. The Chancellor, Jeremy Hunt, likely not to be replaced, even though there will be a reshuffle probably by whoever becomes Prime Minister, because Theresa May just packed it with pretty substandard candidates who are just loyal supporters. Jeremy Hunt has to deliver that full financial statement then on the 31st of October with things like OBR forecasts in order to try and reset our economy and try and convince the markets to calm down, essentially, because of the damage done by Liz Truss. So that is the process that we're going to follow next week. So either a new Prime Minister on Monday, potentially if too many candidates have stood up, and at the moment it looks like Boris Johnson, Rishi Sunak, Kemi Badenoch, Penny Mordaunt are the names that are going. There might be one or two others dabbling. Suella Braverman might go for it. If there are fewer candidates, if there's sort of more unity within the party, then we'll have a proper race all next week, well, as much as proper race as you can call it, with two candidates, and we'll know by Friday who the Prime Minister is.
Vincent, you mentioned Boris Johnson also up for contention there. He stepped aside on only September the 6th. Is he actually in with a good shot at becoming Prime Minister again?
I think if he manages to get through to the second, if it goes two rounds and he manages to get through to the second round where it's a vote of party members, Boris Johnson will be Prime Minister once again, completely.
Wow.
Because that's 160,000, 170,000 Conservative Party members around the country. We're all very annoyed at Boris Johnson being taken in all the polling over the summer when they were given the option of Liz Truss, Rishi Sunak, or Boris Johnson come back. They overwhelmingly kept picking Boris Johnson to come back. So I think if it goes through to that vote, he will be Prime Minister again. But if it's too many candidates in the field, he might have his support too diluted and lose out on Monday.
I tell you what, Vincent, hearing you walk through that rather convoluted scenario just now, imagine the people of, you know, like a put-upon, poorer part of town in East End London sitting there watching TV or reading their copy of The Sun or The Mirror in the midst of a cost-of-living crunch, runaway inflation. You've got a war over the road on the continent raging in Ukraine. Power bills, I think you said the other day, now in Britain, heading towards $10,000 a year. It must just look like the most despicable indulgence to people.
I think it has. I think there's genuine anger tonight in Britain about the state of affairs, about the fact that really, and I have to say, I mean, this is the culmination of the vote that we took now 6 years and 4 months ago. The vote on Brexit, which David Cameron promised the electorate at the 2015 election just to try and get a small majority, and because he was overly worried about UKIP, he promised that vote. He didn't structure the vote properly, just having a simple majority. He failed in his campaigning, and he allowed, and what was allowed to happen was that the people who are the ultra-Brexiteers within the Conservative Party have won that vote then. They didn't have a real plan. They were so shocked they won, but it then fell to Theresa May to deliver the undeliverable. Then it fell to Boris Johnson, who got caught up by and fell by his own foibles and his own personality flaws. And finally, those ultra-Brexiteers managed to get a candidate who in effect was a vessel candidate. Liz Truss has gone from Lib Dem in her youth to Conservative, staunch Republican to Monarchist, Leaver to Remainer. She is so politically shallow and has no strong set of cause or beliefs or anything like that. The only belief that she had was a misguided belief in her own competency, which has been shown to be wrong. But the true Brexiteers thought that she was their girl, thought that they would get what they wanted, and she ran their plan, which was rapid deregulation and low taxation, moving the UK to a more US Republican style / Singapore on Thames, we'll undercut the EU, let's do it. And that was the plan that she launched. And that was wholly rejected by the markets. It's not something the British people had voted for. And to try and turn the established G7 UK economy into what they were doing in a time of economic and geopolitical crisis was an absolutely crazy idea. And this shows that really a lot of the promises that were made six years ago, 4 months, on Brexit, what they were was that they were lies, that they weren't possible, that people were really missold a lot of fake things, and that's been shown by what's happened to Theresa May, what's happened to Liz Truss. It's been shown by the fact that our economy has taken such a hit now and everyone's mortgages have gone up as a result. And all of those Brexit opportunities, well, they seem to have vanished that they were claiming would be there. And you're going to get a scenario now where maybe they'll say, like anyone that's, you know, ever tried to run communism, oh, that wasn't proper communism and, you know, the situation wasn't right, da-da-da. Those Brexiteers might try and stick to that and say, oh, we didn't get a proper shot at delivering truest Brexit. But frankly, they finally now, after burning through two other prime ministers, had their chance with Liz Truss to do it. And the free market, which is their overriding principle, rejected them.
It really is just a stunning disaster on every level. Great analysis, really great analysis, Vincent. We're lucky to have you as part of our program. Vincent McAvinney, our UK correspondent, thank you so much.
Now, Rodney on the Foodland Supermarkets live stream just shot through a message. We're on holiday in the UK at the moment, and it's been very entertaining watching all of this unfold. At least having a clown in charge of a circus makes sense. Thank you, Rodney. Hope you're enjoying your trip to the UK. Let's get to traffic for your drive-in with summer just around the corner. Beat the rush. Get your air conditioning sorted now with Mannix.
Thanks, Lucy. A couple of crashes to look out for this morning. One at Seaford Rise, Griffiths Drive at Commercial Road. That intersection is currently blocked. Find another way if you normally head that way to work. Modbury, another collision. This one's on North East Road near Kelly Road. And at CV Downs, we've got a lane out of action there. Majors Road near Ocean Boulevard. Slow going at the moment. Speeds down to 40 km. Cameras, few of those around too. Grey Terrace, Rosewater. And you'll find another one, Port Road at Cheltenham. Order your sea coffee on the OTR app and enjoy a freshly ground barista-made coffee. It's as easy as click and collect. Making life easy. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Everyday low prices, any time of year. Trust the mighty South Aussies. Great food lives here. Foodland. The mighty South Aussies, yeah.
You're watching the 5AA live stream, thanks to Foodland.
Today, Hyundai believes so. Take the Tucson, Hyundai's midsize SUV, featuring a revolutionary look, intuitive interior, advanced tech, and safety. You can enjoy all this in the Tucson Turbo Diesel all-wheel drive. Available now. Tomorrow's car is here today. Hyundai Tucson, in stock now. Visit Hyundai.com.au. Imagine that, Hyundai.
Callum here for Edwardstown Mazda with amazing news. We have the incredible Mazda CX-9 in stock ready for immediate delivery. Reserve yours now and ask about our 5-day turnaround promise. Only at Edwardstown Mazda.
It's gotta be.
LMBD 207428.
5AA's Tech Talk with your host, Adelaide Tech Guy Richard Pascoe. Thanks to Harvey Norman Computers.
Last month, we spoke about the best new laptop of 2022, HP's Envy X360. Well, it just got better. Harvey Norman has added a special new bonus. Not only do you get a 2-for-1 device that has a flip screen to make it more like a tablet, and fast, reliable computing with 16GB of RAM and a 512GB solid-state drive. On top of all these incredible specs, you'll also score a bonus $300 Harvey Norman gift card. the perfect excuse to grab some accessories or even treat yourself to a new coffee machine. All yours with a beautifully designed HP Envy, available now at Harvey Norman for only $1,999.
Check out this great offer at 5AA.com.au. Thanks to Harvey Norman Computers.
Doesn't matter what level you're at, Drummond Golf can improve your game. I've got Shane from Drummond Golf with me. Now, Shane, help us out here. What's the quickest way to improve our game?
Thanks, Rowie. I know this might sound a bit strange, but how often do you get your car serviced?
Oh, once every 6 months.
So why not get your game regularly serviced with either a lesson at the range or utilise one of our ultimate training aids? The two best training aids we have is the Orange Whip Tempo Trainer and the Swing Guide. The Swing Guide is by far the best training tool that attaches to your golf club and keeps you on plane.
And of course, the expert advice to help you get the most out of your game.
That's why we're here, Rowie.
So see Shane and the team at Drummond Golf, absolute legends at Enfield, Darlington, Mile End, Tea Tree Gully and West Beach Driving Range.
Save up to $30,000 on premium upgrades when you build with Rivergum Homes. Choose from up to 27 quality options and upgrade your home and your life with stylish kitchen appliances and stone bench tops, home automation, premium flooring and a solar energy pack with EV charger. But for a limited time only, go to rivergumhomes.com.au or visit any of our displays at Seaford, Parafield, Anglevale, Playford Alive or Mount Barker. Terms and conditions apply.
Kate Collins and Brenton Radless, the faces you know and the team you can trust. Nine News, made in Adelaide for Adelaide.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings, 5AA Breakfast.
Good morning to you, David. Have you got your golf swing at the ready?
Well, it's a swing of sorts, Luce. I wouldn't say it's going to be used in any training video soon, but...
Oh, that's all right, because we've got one to show.
Oh, no. Oh, no. There's a lot of golf going on around here at the moment. There's a big... Rare Find Foundation Golf Day today, which is a hugely important charity that raises money for...
Kate's involved.
She is. I will disclose that proudly, that my wife is involved with Anna Pakpoy, who founded it. And they're having a big golf day today. House Inspect Australia, our good mates there, have got a team in. And 5AA's got a team in it too. So it's an excellent excuse and cause to go and swing the wrenches on a beautiful... spring day like this one.
Good. Well, the 5AA team, hopefully they're warming up for our own 5AA golf day in about 10 days' time, I should say. All thanks to Adelaide Exposed Concrete, we being David and some other favourite presenters, not myself.
Can you play, Luce?
No, not at all. Yeah. I once hit a golf ball and instead of going up in the air, it went really fast but along the ground.
No, well, that sounds exactly like what happens every time I go out.
Which I believe is more hockey.
Yeah, well... doesn't matter, as long as it gets there.
Oh,
that's my rationalisation.
The club
for
made
grubbers.
Contact with the ball. That's all I was happy with.
That doesn't always happen, so that's good.
We are calling a winner before 8 o'clock this morning. Keep your phones handy. If you have registered to get a team together in the 5AA Golf Day, keep your phone ready. And don't miss out now, because if you aren't who we're calling today, you can still register at 5AA.com.au. For the meat trade today, we are asking, who are you named after? What have you named your kids after? Is there a story behind your name? Daryl in Virginia, good morning.
Good morning. I was actually named after my mum's deceased boyfriend from the 1960s. I don't know how she got that past Dad, but...
Daryl, how do you feel about that?
Oh, I guess it's a memory, I suppose.
There's a story behind it, yep.
He was from the Riverland, died in a plane crash, and... Yeah, she was only about 15 or 16 at the time, and
That's terribly
sad. That. Yeah, but also on a side note, I didn't know, I've got a auntie Liz and an uncle Phil, and I didn't realise that they were named after the Royals because they were born in 1954 when the Queen was making her visit.
Wonderful.
Wow, and that's why they were christened with those names.
Yeah, they were born in Prospect, and I think she was driving past. Oh, two good names, and then Auntie Margaret came along afterwards.
So, there you go. Daryl's got the full royal family. Fantastic. Thank you, Daryl. Janelle in Mawson Lakes, good morning.
Good morning. I was named after a racehorse that my grandfather had won on, but sadly it broke its leg and got shot. after. So, needless to say, I've been very careful about breaking bones.
Absolutely, Janelle.
You don't want to become a glue stick. Good on you, Janelle.
Thank you, Janelle. This text on the Automasters text line. If you ask my parents in front of their church friends, then I'm named after Luke from the Bible. But anyone else, I'm named after Luke Skywalker. I'm going to assume that's from Luke.
I like this one from Con. Where's it gone? Con, talking about the excellent Greek habit of naming your kids after your parents. If you go to any Greek wedding, you walk around the room, just call out Nick or Jim, and you've got a 50% chance of getting the name of every man in the room right.
Here it is, Con. Greek tradition says a firstborn is usually named after a grandparent, but I was born in May when St. Constantine is celebrated, so Con it was.
Well, my two eldest kids, my ex-wife and I, we obviously honoured the Greek tradition. So my daughter, her middle name is Tula, after her late grandma, her late Yaya. And then Jim, he's James Lloyd. And Jim is from Dimitri, which is George's late father, and middle name Lloyd is my old man. So all of our kids are family names. Then Sam, his middle name is Chris, which is Kate's late father, who died tragically when Kate was very young. And then Charlie has got Frederick as his middle name. My late Uncle Fred served in Vietnam, great man, taken too soon, died about 8 years ago. So I think having family running through names, yeah. I think I love that from the Greek culture, and other cultures do it too. I reckon a lot of people would do that with their naming.
It's a very sweet sentiment.
I want to know, what's the Rosie story though? We've got to get Wilhelm up and about.
I know. Come on. I'd like to know what Rowie's named after. Enjoy the same feeling you get with a new Toyota on a Toyota certified pre-owned car at North Point Toyota. Last night, Rowie caught up with Caro discussing the magic round.
Premier Peter Malinauskas has wooed you Victorians in it. Coming to us.
Victoria was never going for it, you clown. The only thing standing between Magic Round and Adelaide is the Commission's decision as to whether or not it's going to happen. There's broadcasting situations to be sorted out. There's the players. The clubs have broadly all agreed and been very supportive, although there is a huge appetite now for Magic Round to make its debut in Adelaide. You know, everyone wants to have it first.
Of course they do.
Everyone wants to host it first. And if you don't host it first, are you going to want it second? This is the question. And if South Australia gets it in year one, will they want it in year two?
That's a very good point, because I reckon there'll be heaps of hoopla for the first one. After that, it might be a bit, yeah. But the first one, I love the idea of the Barossa game.
The Barossa is the real high point, I think.
Yeah.
Let's hope we get it.
You know where they should play a game too? Penashaw. Have you seen that oval at Penashaw? When you get off sea links,
yeah, overlooks the.
That's got to be one of the best ovals in the world.
Let's hope we get it.
It's stunning.
Fingers crossed. Be great for the state.
If everyone in KO went though, you'd have 4,000 people in the game.
That's all right.
They probably want a bigger crowd.
They want some numbers. Yeah. 4,000 it will be. That's you can catch more with Rowie tonight at 4 o'clock. Where's my credit for Rowie? Enjoy the same feeling you get with a new Toyota at North Point Toyota. Back after the 7:30 news.
If you want to build a new home, something that reflects you and your lifestyle, then you really need to speak with Beechwood Homes. And just so you know, they won't try and sell you a house plan. In fact, there's no house plans until you tell them what you want. So go for it. Start thinking of all the possibilities or get in touch with Beechwood Homes for a few thought starters. Life's good. It's even better in a Beechwood home. Google Beechwood Adelaide.
Introducing Nissan Future Value Business Plus, a new fleet finance solution for small to medium businesses offering competitive weekly repayments, including the cost of scheduled servicing for the loan term. Available now on the all-new Nissan X-Trail ST. Plan confidently for the road ahead with Nissan Future Value Business Plus. Visit nissan.com.au/businessplus or contact your local Nissan dealer. Approved ABN registered small to medium fleet applicants of Nissan Financial Services. T's and C's and exclusions apply.
There's been plenty of talk about interest rate rises having an impact on the real estate market, but there are still a lot of buyers keen to find their perfect home.
And Adelaide's become a national property hotspot, with home values here outpacing every other capital city.
We know our friends at Toop & Toop work across all suburbs, and we can tell you right now they are working with 5,212 buyers in Medindie, 5,481 in Dulwich, and 5,959 in Unley, and they're all searching for their perfect property in these specific locations.
So if you're thinking of we're selling and would like to know how many buyers Toop and Toop are working with in your suburb, just go to their website, toop.com.au.
5AA Breakfast is streaming live right now. To watch, simply head online to 5AA Facebook or search 5AA on YouTube. This is Adelaide's 5AA.
Partly cloudy and 23 today with the 7:30 news. I'm Mel Usher. A woman's died after a hit run at Murray Bridge East last night. She was hit by a car on the Old Princess Highway just before 10. The vehicle didn't stop. Senior Constable Kimberly Broad says the 40-year-old from Murray Bridge died at the scene.
Investigations are continuing to locate the vehicle involved. And we've got major crash investigators urging anyone who witnessed the crash and hasn't yet spoken with police or was perhaps driving in that area at that time, 9:45 last night, who possibly has some dash cam footage, if they please contact Crime Stoppers.
The woman's death is the 58th life lost on our roads this year, compared to 79 at this time a year ago. British Prime Minister Liz Truss has fallen on her sword. She's resigned after the shortest ever residence at Downing Street. The opposition is calling for a general election. Current laws don't require a public vote to be held until next year, and Conservatives such as ex-PM Boris Johnson are throwing their hats in the ring to be appointed from within the party. Labour leader Sir Keir Starmer says the country needs stability.
We are ready to form a government to stabilise the economy and implement a real plan for growth, for living standards, to help people through a cost of living crisis. And that's the choice now. A stable Labour government or this utter chaos from the Conservatives.
UK correspondent Adam Gilchrist says she inherited a mess.
A fairly rough state. I mean, you know, the way the numbers were going, and she made the numbers worse. So inflation going up, interest rates going up. I mean, mortgages have gone through the roof. Economic policy flawed, the pound going down, all sorts of issues.
The SES will transport 70,000 empty sandbags and 50 tonnes of sand to the Riverland today. They'll assist residents prepare for increased flows in the coming weeks. Up to 120 gigalitres a day is predicted to stream down the River Murray into SA by early December in the wake of the flood crisis interstate. Major changes to trading hours in SA have been welcomed by retailers. New legislation will allow shops to open from 9am on Sundays and suburban stores to trade on Boxing Day. Roger Drake from Drake Supermarket says the changes strike the right balance.
I think it's common sense, and if I talk to my counterparts in Victoria, the independents, they think we've got the best trading hours in the country.
Australians are being warned cyber attacks are the new norm as Medibank customers are the latest to be put at risk. Millions of people are anxiously waiting to see if their personal medical information will be leaked. The personal records could be made public if the criminals get their way, with concerns individuals will become the target of blackmail. Cybersecurity Minister Claire O'Neill has told Nine the federal government is doing all it can to mitigate the threat.
If anything happens to put this into the public realm, it will be an absolute dog act. And that's why the Australian government has really muscled up here. We are weighing in very heavily to help Medibank with this situation, and I'm very focused and occupied with this task.
A New York jury has cleared Kevin Spacey of sexual assault. It's found he did not molest fellow actor Anthony Rapp in 1986 and was not liable for battery. And the Powerball didn't go off last night. The jackpot next week will be $160 million. That's the biggest lottery prize the nation has ever seen. Now turning to 5AA Sport.
All new 2022 Mitsubishi Outlander with 10-year warranty, 10 years capped price servicing at Agostino Mitsubishi.
And the Redbacks are back in action today, Tom Reed.
Yeah, let's hope for a bit of a change of fortunes, Mel, hoping they can bounce back. They take on Tasmania a little bit later this morning. Now Sri Lanka and the Netherlands, they've qualified meantime for the Super 12 stage at the T20 World Cup. The Sri Lankans securing their place with a 16-run win over the Dutch. Let's go to football round 9 in the AFLW kicks off today with Adelaide taking on Geelong at Unley Oval. Crows captain Chelsea Randall is out with an ankle injury. Coach Matthew Clark says they're looking to bounce back after last week's loss.
We'd love to be able to win both these last games, give ourselves a chance for top four, which is obviously the better run once you're in the finals. But ultimately, that'll become a new competition once we reach that point.
The Adelaide 36ers are up against the Sydney Kings in the NBL tonight. Kings guard Angus Glover says it will be a tough game.
They've come off a win against an NBA team in the Phoenix Suns, but they're the first NBL team to do it. So they've got talent all the way through their roster.
And there were two games last night with Cairns 4-point winners against Melbourne United, while the South East Melbourne Phoenix broke New Zealand's 3-game winning streak with a 22-point win. To soccer now, pressure is mounting on under fire Aston Villa manager Steven Gerrard following another horror night, this time going down 3-0 against Fulham.
Still gets away from Cash. An own goal! An own goal to cap off an evening that Aston Villa will want to forget.
Yeah, not good for them. Audio thanks to Optus. Another match is very close to full time with Leicester currently 2-0 up against Leeds. And that's the 5AA sport.
Now checking 5AA traffic.
Look out for a crash at Seaford Rise. That's Griffith Drive at Commercial Road. That intersection is currently blocked, so avoid it if you can. CV Downs outbound. We've got a lane out of action there. Majors Road near Ocean Boulevard. Slow going with speeds out of 40. And we're also slow at Brighton. Brighton Road near Sturt Road with works. Speeds are 40 there too. Cameras, Wamma Road, Penfield and Port Road at Cheltenham. Preparing a boat for the season ahead, REA now has marine batteries to keep you moving on your adventures. Search REA Battery, T's and C's apply. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
5AA forecast, and we're looking for a top of 23 today, partly cloudy, a shower or two tomorrow, 21, Sunday a shower or two, 18. Right now it's 17 degrees. More news as it happens on 5AA.
G'day, it's Baz from Fleurieu Milk Company. South Australian dairy farmers are doing it tough right now, but at Fleurieu Milk, we always look after our own, and you can too. When you reach for milk, reach for Fleurieu Milk and help support our hard-working South Australian dairy farmers and their families. Because right now, they need our help. Three words make all the difference. Fleurieu Milk Company. South Australian first and proud of it.
Just send it. It's not just your deliveries that ASIC couriers look after. They're also proud supporters of the community. Chris, tell us more.
That's right, Rowie. At ASIC Couriers, we're proud supporters of over 16 sporting clubs. We also work with and support the Breakthrough Mental Health Research Foundation to strive for a happy and positive workplace. By supporting us, you're also supporting the community. Don't just send it.
Curtis here, in-season Aussie fruit and veg at Coles. It's in abundance, in-season and great value. The easy way to feed your family healthy. Like Coles Kensington Pride Mangoes. They're sweet, tangy, rich and juicy. Perfect to use in a smoothie, on top of your yogurt or eat just as they are. And my best tip for mangoes is to ripen them in a bowl, then store them in the fridge. In-season Aussie fruit and veg at Coles. That's value the Australian way.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings, 5AA Breakfast.
Good morning to you. 7:37 this Friday, 23 degrees, partly cloudy. We're catching up with Bruce Abernathy after 8 o'clock this morning.
Yes.
David, a new car show is premiering on Channel 7 tomorrow,
I believe. He's tapping into his inner Peter Werrett for fans to reference another 1970s TV show, Luce, that will have you looking at me blankly as if I'm having another old guy moment.
The like great right
show,
now.
Talk, T-O-R-Q-U-E.
Excellent.
An excellent program.
We'll catch up with Bruce after 8 o'clock. It is, of course, Meet Tray Friday call day. We want to hear who or what situation you were named after. But first, we're going to head to Canberra with Phil Currey.
I've asked Senator Thorpe for her resignation as Deputy Leader in the Senate. At a minimum, Senator Thorpe needed to disclose to me her connection to Mr. March. She has assured me that there has been no breach, but nonetheless, this was a significant error of judgment.
That is, of course, Greens leader Adam Bandt. Phil from the Australian Financial Review, good morning to you.
Good morning, Lucy.
Hey, Phil, conflicts of interest don't come much more spectacular than this one, do they?
I forgot to tell you, I was dating a bike.
Not just a bikie, the head of the actual biker gang.
Yeah, he was the brother of Dustin Martin's father.
Yeah.
Who was also a bikie, who Peter Dutton deported.
That's about right.
5 years ago.
Yeah.
Because he's a bad character. Yeah, no, it doesn't get any juicier than this. Look, the problem with your Thorpe is she's a Green Senator, Victorian. She's new. She's a sort of real militant sort of person. She's been nothing but trouble for Adam Pan since she's come in. I think it's a classic case of you sort of draft someone for your party thinking they're going to be an attribute because they've got a bit of a profile as a rabble rouser. He finds it's almost once a week now he's having to either stand up or go into hiding because of something she's done. And This one sort of has a serious edge to it, Dave, because she was sitting on a committee in Parliament that looked into issues of justice, including bikie gang crime, whilst at the same time she didn't disclose this relationship. Now, I think what sort of gives it a bit of zing on top of that is the Greens are probably the most sanctimonious party in the Parliament when it comes to, accusing everyone else of being corrupt or rotten or something like that. And, Adam Bandt didn't like the questions yesterday when it was put to him, should this be referred to the new National Anti-Corruption Committee? But, this is the sort of thing he'd be demanding if it was one of the major parties. So,
it's different from giving $20,000 to a tennis club in a marginal seat. I mean, sure, that might be worthy of scrutiny, but at the same time, I would have thought if you're being briefed by the AFP in a secret parliamentary inquiry about the fact that the AFP might be about to conduct a series of raids against biker gangs over meth distribution. Yeah. Meanwhile, this woman sort of like, meanwhile, 8 hours later over the family dinner table, it's like, so dear, how was your day? What did you get up to at work today?
that's the connotation, isn't it? We don't know, we don't know whether that actually happened. But that's just what you expose yourself to if you don't disclose these sorts of things. So, look, the Greens don't waste your time telling every other party how to behave. So, it's on them now. I heard Peter Dutton saying she should quit the Parliament. I don't know. You can't sack a senator.
No.
You can sack someone from the party and they just sit there as an independent on the crossbench. But it would be down to her. If something was found wrong, she'd have to leave. But I don't think there's no one saying anything wrong has occurred other than the conflict. So,
given what a rabble rouser she's been while she was inside the tent and dutifully performing on the front bench for Adam Bandt, it's interesting to reflect on the fact that she might now even be more of a loose cannon, Phil, that she's been cut loose.
I think it might be the other way around, Dave. She put out a statement yesterday. It was very contrite and, conforming, if you like.
Okay.
I think maybe she realised that this is not a good look and this will seriously jeopardise her career. Lydia's not one to be told how to behave. She's done the sort of the black power salute in the Senate when she's being sworn in. And, I don't mind her in one sense. She's just a good a character around the place. But that's one thing. But this is, this is actually serious. This is a, sackable sort of offence. So I suspect if she doesn't pull her head in now, she won't.
Yeah. Great stuff, as always, Phil. Phil Currie, the political editor for the Australian Financial Review. We'll chat next week, mate.
Thanks, Phil. Very good. Don't forget you can tune in on the YouTube and Facebook live stream. Thanks to Foodland Supermarkets, and text in on the Automasters text line 0448 08 1395.
Big thanks to the guys at Blackwood Country Meats for today's meat tray. Dane and the team. It's an excellent little butcher shop. We love giving our little suburban family-run butcher shops a plug. That's the key reason Meat Tray Friday exists, aside from obviously being an excellent vehicle for frivolity.
Dane's been a long time meat tray donator, so thank you heaps, Dane. Now we're heading to Michael Smith from 7 News in for his flashback segment on Sunday nights. Morning, Michael.
Good morning, Lucy and David. I reckon, Lucy, that your dad's going to particularly like this week's flashback, because if my memory serves me correctly, he played for North Adelaide, didn't he?
He sure did. So please tell me it's a North Adelaide-themed flashback.
I think you know that it is. We're heading back to a time a little before when he would have been playing. In fact, 50 years ago this week, when not only were the Roosters back-to-back SANFL premiers, but they were crowned the best team in the nation after winning the Champions of Australia tournament. Now, for people who don't remember what that was, the best teams, the premiership teams from each state, came to Adelaide in 1972 to face off against each other. So Carlton had won the VFL Grand Final. They came here. East Perth came from the WAFL. And a team called City South from Launceston came up to represent Tasmania. And they all played off against each other at the Adelaide Oval for the ultimate bragging rights. It was a notable competition for a number of reasons. It was the first time a major footy match had ever been played on a Sunday in Adelaide. And for Carlton to make the grand final, they had a particularly memorable and very bruising encounter with East Perth. Mal Brown was their skipper, and he basically put on a Muhammad Ali-style boxing session in the middle of the Adelaide Oval, tenderising a few of the Carlton players, which might have made it slightly easier for the Roosters the next day. The conditions for the final were breezy. It was a cold day. It was a thrilling match. North Adelaide won by 1 point.
The
winning
Roosters.
Goal. Yes, kicked by Darryl Webb. But it really was a big team effort. And although if you ask some of the Carlton players, there was one particular player that stood out for the Roosters. Have a listen to Robert Walls, who was Carlton's vice-captain at the time.
The Carlton players, every one of them, all thought that Barry Robson was the pick of them all. He could go left side and kick the ball equally as well as he could on his right side. He could take a spectacular high mark. He could pick the ball up off his bootlaces. Obviously, he didn't come to play in the VFL, but had he come, he would have been an absolute champion, no doubt about that.
I love hearing that, Michael. Robert Walls actually went on to coach my dad at Fitzroy.
There you go. That's another Logan family connection.
That's right.
The story goes that on the day that even Alex Jezelenko was so in awe of the skills of Barry Robson that he actually gave him a round of applause on the Adelaide Oval. So on Flashback this Sunday night on 7 News, we'll hear from Barry Robson. He's such a humble man, always puts it down to the team, but he was an incredible footballer. We'll hear from him, Bowden Jaworski and Darryl Webb, who kicked that winning goal. But famously, for people who remember it, his last kick of the match wasn't so good. He sent the ball off into the members' stand at the Adelaide Oval. But it was a thrilling win by the Roosters. 1 point against Carlton to be crowned the champions of Australia 50 years ago this week.
Excellent. Fantastic. Up the Roosters. Thank you very much, Michael. That is 7 News Flashback, 6 p.m. on Sunday night.
So did your dad play with Paul Roos at Fitzroy Lakes?
He sure did, yes.
Yeah, they'd be about the same age.
Yeah.
Roosie's probably a little bit older than him.
I will admit I don't know the correct age of Paul Roos.
So did it go Fitzroy to Brisbane Bears?
They merged.
Yeah, yeah. Yep. So Fitzroy ceased to exist and became the Bears and became the Lions.
No, sorry. Brisbane Bears merged with the Fitzroy Lions.
Of course, that's right.
To become the Brisbane Lions.
So was your
based
dad
in Melbourne
there when all that was happening?
Or no, that was in the 90s. My dad left there at the end of 89.
Yeah, right.
I believe. Who knows, if he'd stayed on, I could have been a Melbourne girl and this whole
whole
partnership for the next 2 weeks just wouldn't have ever happened.
Or maybe in Brisbane you might be on...
I might not even be in radio.
6PR or something instead.
No, that's Perth.
4BC. 4BC. That's right, that's what I meant.
4BC, let's get to your traffic this morning with summer just around the corner. Beat the rush to get your air conditioning sorted now with Mannix.
Thanks, Lucy. Good as gold for the run-in today. No great hassles or the majors accident or breakdown free. Simply a few works to keep in mind. You'll find a lane closed at Seaview Downs. That's Majors Road near Ocean Boulevard. Speed's reduced there at the moment. Also got a lane out of action at College Park. That's Paynham Road near George Street. And we're slow going for works at Brighton Road near Sturt Road. Got a few cameras. Don't let them ruin your weekend. You'll find them Blacktop Road, One Tree Hill and Great Terrace at Rosewater. Legendary deals are on now. At Barbecues Galore, save up to 50% on selected outdoor furniture. Lots more deals at Barbecues Galore. Now you're cooking. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
The next generation of Mighty South Aussies have spoken.
Equal rights.
For everyone.
Oceans without junk in them.
No nasty chemicals in things.
Search Sustainable 7 to hear more about what the future's got in store for Foodland.
The best bit though, if the part doesn't fit, eBay's got my back with their money back guarantee. That means I can browse, buy, carefree with eBay's money back guarantee.
Don't just send it.
Chris from ASIC Couriers is with us. Chris, you need more drivers.
Absolutely, Rowie. We need more drivers to maintain our highest standard of perfect service. And due to new contracts starting, we need drivers urgently. So if you qualify and join our team now, we'll give you $1,500.
Wow! $1,500?
Yep. If you have a driver's license, you're already qualified. So get in touch with us. Visit asiccouriers.com.au. Conditions apply.
Having a rainwise pool installed is more than an investment in your property. As you well know, David, it is a huge investment in your lifestyle. Nothing beats having friends and family around for a summer of fun poolside.
No, that's right. If you're going to spend a bit of money, do it on something that's really entertaining and that's going to keep you entertained for decades to come. And look, we went with Rainwise Pools for several reasons. Mainly they're just good people, but also they're so good at what they do. And because Rainwise is a family business with family values at the core of everything they do, you're guaranteed to have an exceptional experience.
Rainwise stocks Adelaide's largest range of Conquest fiberglass pools. Conquest have been around for over 50 years, so you know you're getting a quality product installed by the award-winning construction team at Rainwise.
Do you ever? And if you speak with Rainwise this month to organise your pool, they'll even throw in free pool heating. It's for October only, so act now for free heating with your Rainwise pool. Some terms and conditions apply. Visit rainwisepoolsadelaide.com.au.
Luxuriously crafted from the ground up, this is your time to upgrade your lifestyle. Choose from a range of spacious two-bedroom, two-bathroom apartments now selling at Adelaide's most sought-after address, 88 O'Connell. Your prestigious new apartment comes with so much to adore. A ground floor marketplace with bar and dining, pools and gymnasium, retail shopping on your doorstep, and just a short stroll to the city. Apartments are selling fast. Secure yours. Visit 88oconnell.com.
Callum here. Don't forget, Edwardstown Mazda has stock available for delivery with their 5-day turnaround promise, plus amazing service facilities. All the good stuff without the wait. Edwardstown Mazda. It's gotta be. LMBD 207428.
5AA Breakfast is streaming live right now. To watch, simply head online to 5AA Facebook or search 5AA on YouTube. David Penberthy and Will Goodings. 5AA Breakfast.
Good morning to you. It is nearly 8 o'clock this morning. We're in for 23 and partly cloudy for your Friday. It is Meat Tray Friday. Send us in your text. The Automasters text line 0448 08 1395. But in exciting news, have your phones ready. If you have entered on the 5AA website to be a part of the 5AA Golf Day, have your phones handy. We are about to call a winner on air in the next few minutes. So all thanks to Adelaide Exposed Concrete, we are hitting the fairways on the 31st of October. If you aren't our winner today, you can still register for a spot to come and play with David. Rowie and Timmy G will be down there. They're going to do their outside broadcast. There are some guest speakers. There's a two-course sit-down dinner and a beverage package.
Love a good beverage package.
Adelaide Exposed Concrete for helping us out with all of this. What more could you want?
If you want exposed concrete in your life, get it from Adelaide Exposed Concrete. Who doesn't want a bit of exposed concrete? What about you, Sam? Can you play golf?
I try to sometimes, but...
Well, I try to.
We should play then.
Yeah. Are you going to come?
Not too sure.
Sam had the absolute privilege of heading to the golf course the other day with you guys.
Yes. Now, I came with you guys. When did we do it? Wednesday?
We headed down Tuesday.
We headed down to Glenelg Golf.
No, sorry. It was Wednesday, the day I correctly guessed Will's baby name.
Okay. All right, Lucy.
That's my marker. Right.
But yes, we did head down to Glenelg Golf Course. Will and I had the very, very lucky opportunity to watch you get some practice strokes and practice with one of the... It was Ryan from the Glenelg Golf Course. Crikey. Now, if you head to
Ryan, I reckon, as I was walking back to the car, he was shaking his head going... I can't do anything just with this.
Disappointment.
Yeah.
Not at all.
Some people are beyond salvation.
Now, don't be like that, David. But if you head along to the David and Will Twitter page right now, we're about to post the video we put together. And our very own Will Goodings had a go at commentating some golf.
I've never commentated golf, but I know you've got to do it with harsh and reverential tones. And I'm no expert, but there's a gentleman over here whose golf bag drove itself on the golf cart. David got 3 clubs out of his front seat and carried them to this lesson. I don't know, I'm not an expert, but it feels like it matters.
I said, we've witnessed David a bit of a practice.
Putted to a driving bit, like driving range, anyway.
Well, I probably could have hit it about as far as it did with the wood. But it's a beautiful setting. I've never been to a proper private course before because I'm such a sort of occasional hacker.
So,
which makes it even more nerve wracking. The odor of a golf day. There's going to be people there who've got
got 10 days.
All the gear and they're in their +4 knickerbockers with a little Titleist hat, and I'll be wearing my Converse One Stars with the hand-me-down clubs that I got from my dad.
That's all right. Well, let's call our winner this morning and see if they will be joining you. Let's see if they pick up first. This will be interesting.
The tension mounts.
Oh.
Hello.
Hello, is this Catherine?
Yes.
Catherine, you are on air with 5AA Breakfast this morning. It's Lucy and Penbo here. How are you?
Oh, God, thanks, Luce. How are you?
Good, thank you. Now, I believe you are now coming along to our 5AA Golf Day.
Awesome.
I've never hit that celebratory buzzer before. That was quite thrilling for me, as it was for you, Catherine. Congratulations.
Now, Dave, I heard you played at Wollongong yesterday or the day before?
No, going out there, the Savo. Yeah, very excited.
That's my home course. Yeah, that's my home course.
Oh, really? Are you just play regularly there, or are you a member?
Yeah, every Tuesday, Ladies' Day. So.
Oh, lovely. Can you give me a tip on air, Catherine? How do you, is it the fourth, the one with that evil dog leg and the giant dam in the middle of it?
The fourth, yeah, that's the fourth.
What's your approach there? Do you go to the right or do you try to heroically hit over the trees?
No, I hope to get over for three. So if I do a couple of good shots and then head over for three, but sometimes it gets a bit wet. So
I've lost so many balls on that hole.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful course.
My son's a trainee pro at Kiwi, at Kiyonga. So,
oh, really?
He gets over quite comfortably for two, Dave. So, yeah.
Oh, wow. There you go, Dave. You've got some competition with Catherine there at the FIVEAA Golf Day down at Glenelg Golf Club on the 31st. Congrats,
hey,
Catherine.
Excellent.
I'll pop you back to Good Sam. He'll sort you out with your winner's details.
I was talking to another bloke, Simon McWhirter, who's the pro at the North Adelaide Public Course, because I had one lesson with him and my son Jim for Jim's birthday. And he said a good tip for men who are learning the game or want to get better at it is to actually watch professional female golfers, because their technique, they're less... the sort of crazy macho wind up, like
less
trying to
clunky.
Yeah, belt the skin off the ball and doing all the weight transfer stuff. But just, you know, taking all the sort of He-Man stuff out of it and just concentrate on your technique.
Females, I tell you.
Yeah, well, I'm learning this fast. two days in.
What more can I say?
It's all about the technique. Behind the desk, it's like, you know, you're like a duck. You calm up the top. It's all going on underneath. But
yeah, let's not jinx it too much. Seriously, the nervous sweats are back for day two. Let's get to Blakey this morning. Aussie Fast Transport Solutions, interstate freight distribution, warehousing and local Adelaide couriers. Call Aussie Fast on 13 13 64.
This week, a study into NAPLAND test results showed that our kids aren't very good at spelling and grammar. Some students in Year 9 constructing sentences at the level of Year 7 students. A lot of us, when we heard that, said, yeah, we knew that without the NAPLAND tests.
It was a NAPLAND testing. All the folks hope they do well. Because we got to keep checking those kids so we be able to tell.
I keep checking them.
If they can read and write or if their grammar is going to hell. And the results came back and said Australian kids really can't spell. They found that most of the kids didn't know what an apostrophe's for.
What?
And they didn't use a comma in a sentence, and that lowered their score.
Oh, boy.
But that's the way they text their friends when they give them a bell.
Always a little smile.
No surprise to the old folks, Australian kids really can't spell. See it all the time, people round about that age.
The young ones.
They say mischievous instead of mischievous, they also say H.
Oh,
they're saying nuclear, not nuclear, espresso, not espresso, what the hell?
What the hell?
And pronunciation, that's a good one, because they really can't spell.
Makes no sense.
They don't know what a colon is, they really haven't learned that in class.
What?
Or maybe they have, but they confuse it with the one in their ass. They say succinct instead of succinct, probably in February as well. The English language is dead, cause today's kids really can't spell. The English language is dead, cause today's kids really can't spell.
John Blake. On the same page as me for many of those.
I couldn't get the image of John Travolta and Uma Thurman out of my head then. You know what I'm talking about, Lee?
Yeah, yeah, Pulp Fiction, the famous dance scene.
What a movie.
Embarrassingly, I haven't seen the movie, but I know the scene.
Seriously, you got to see it. It's just the most mind-blowingly great film ever.
Coming up, we have a very special guest for Breaking at 8. Back shortly.
Hi, it's Eddie May from NRG Solar. Did you know solar is still the cheapest form of power in South Australia? So if you're not going solar, you're paying too much for your electricity. Jump on board now before the government rebates fall again at the end of December. Act now and you can save thousands of dollars on a typical system tailor-made for you. If you wait until next year, those savings simply won't be there. Get in touch today. Visit nrgsolar.com.au because solar is all we do.
Mini Jumpbuck, now in McLaren Vale, make Australia's favourite wool bedding products, proudly made right here in South Australia. Mini Jumpbuck uses the finest Australian wool to handcraft their quilts, mattress toppers, pillows and more. If you're looking to improve your quality of sleep, start with a visit to Mini Jumpbuck McLaren Vale today. You'll find some great specials in store, along with fabulous gift ideas for adults and children, or to spoil yourself. Mini Jumpbuck McLaren Vale, open 7 days, Australian made, Australian owned.
Kate Collins and Brendan Radless, the faces you know and the team you can trust. Nine News, made in Adelaide for Adelaide.
Online, on DAB Digital Radio and on 1395 AM. Talking Adelaide. This is Adelaide's 5AA.
Partly cloudy, 23 today with the 8 o'clock news. I'm Mel Usher. Police are hunting the driver involved in a fatal hit run at Murray Bridge East last night. A 40-year-old woman was struck by a car on the Old Princes Highway just before 10 p.m. She died at the scene. The vehicle failed to stop after the crash. It's the 58th life lost on SA roads this year, 21 less than last year. The British Prime Minister has sensationally resigned. UK correspondent Brett McLeod reports.
Liz Truss bowed to the inevitable when she stepped out of No. 10 Downing Street to announce that after just 44 days, she was quitting as Prime Minister, a record short stay in office. What support remained among Tory MPs collapsed after chaotic scenes in the House of Commons yesterday. Among the likely contenders to replace her, former Chancellor Rishi Sunak and former Prime Minister Boris Johnson, who's broken his Caribbean holiday to return to Britain. The winner will be announced next week.
The flood crisis continues interstate. Floodwaters are threatening hundreds of homes along the New South Wales-Victorian border, while evacuation orders remain in place for parts of Echuca and Moama, where flooding is expected to peak. At least 140,000 sandbags have been laid to protect homes and businesses. Local resident Craig says the community is tired but united.
A bit worn out, but just got to keep going. What else do we do? Just need as many as we can to help out while we still got the chance to. Let's beat this water.
And locally, the SES will transport 70,000 empty sandbags and 50 tonnes of sand to the Riverland today. They'll assist residents preparing for an increase in flows in the coming weeks. Infectious diseases experts say adapting vaccines to emerging COVID variants won't work in the long term. Vaccines are only just now being updated to provide protection against Omicron subvariants, BA4 and 5, but there are new strains appearing overseas already. Dr. Paul Griffin says we need a vaccine that provides broader protection.
There are lots of clinical trials of even better vaccines. There's over 125 in clinical trials, and hopefully some of those will be better at doing things like stopping transmission to a higher degree and needing to be updated less frequently than the vaccines we have at the moment.
Kate Blanchett will be here tonight as part of the Adelaide Film Festival. She'll attend the Australian premiere of her new movie Tar at the Capri in Goodwood. Blanchett will walk the red carpet and take part in a Q&A. And the Powerball has jackpotted after no one's numbers came up last night. Next week, it'll be worth a record $160 million. Now turning to 5AA Sport.
All new 2022 Mitsubishi Outlander with 10-year warranty. 10 years capped price servicing at Agostino Mitsubishi.
And it's over to Tom Wren.
Thank you, Mel. AFL clubs will receive a $500,000 boost each from next year's Magic Round. The round will involve all 18 teams playing in the one city, with Adelaide right in the mix along with New South Wales to host the round. Ross Lyon, meantime, has declared he's again fallen in love with St Kilda, 11 years after walking out on the club. Lyon could be confirmed as the Saints' new coach as early as today and is eager to be reunited.
Like, I'm keen. Like, my heart's been opened up to St Kilda through Andrew and Simon and their board.
Plenty of cricket on at the moment. South Australia will take on Tasmania in a Marsh one-day cup clash a little bit later this morning. The Redbacks looking to bounce back after a 7-wicket loss in the Shield earlier this week. Meantime, the T20 World Cup rolls on today, with the West Indies needing a win against Ireland to progress to the Super 12 stage. It's a similar story in the late game when Scotland takes on Zimbabwe. Australia begins its campaign against New Zealand tomorrow. The Adelaide 36ers will take on the Sydney Kings in what's looming as a bit of a grudge match a little bit later tonight. That's after the Kings owner Paul Smith accused the Adelaide 36ers of carrying on following their win in the US. Aussie Alex de Minaur has set up a mouth-watering quarter-final clash against Denis Shapovalov at the Stockholm Open after he easily took care of American JJ Wolf in their second-round clash. A strong start for Aussie Cam Davis at the CG Cup in South Carolina. He's fired an impressive 5-under-66 and sits only one shot off joint American leaders Gary Woodland and Trey Mullinax. And the Major League Baseball playoffs will continue this morning with the New York Yankees taking on the Houston Astros. The Astros took care of the Yankees in Game 1 of the Best of 7 series yesterday, winning 4-2. And that's the 5AA Sport.
Now checking 5AA traffic.
Smooth sailing for the run-in today, which is excellent. Simply some works to keep in mind. You'll find a lane out of action at Seaview Downs. That's Majors Road near Ocean Boulevard. West Lakes got another lane out of action. West Lakes Boulevard near Brebner Drive. And we're slow going for works at Angle Park, South Road near Katina Streets. Look out for cameras this morning. Tolmer Road, Elizabeth Park and Trimmer Parade at Seaton. Telstra's flash sale is now on. Get a bonus Samsung Galaxy Watch 5 with selected Samsung Galaxy phones. Offer ends October 24. Redemption criteria and conditions apply. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
5AA weather, a top of 23 for your Friday and partly cloudy. The weekend, a shower or two tomorrow, 21. Sunday, a shower or two, 18. And then Monday, a possible shower, also 18. Right now, it's 18 degrees. More news as it happens on 5AA.
There's more than deals at a Toyota dealership, like the expert care you get when you service your Toyota with us. You'll know you're in safe hands because all work is done by Toyota-trained technicians who use specialised diagnostic equipment designed specifically for Toyotas. We only use Toyota genuine parts for any part that needs replacing. And you can book your service online or via My Toyota to make life easier.
Jarvis Toyota, South Road, Clovelly Park.
Oh, what a feeling. Toyota.
Building amazing homes is important to Beechwood Homes, and so is the environment. So when you build with Beechwood, you're building a better environment for our kids and grandkids. Here's why. Around 70% of scrap materials from every Beechwood home is recycled. Bricks, rubble, timber, gyprock and steel, none of it goes to landfill. It's all sorted and recycled. So life really is good. It's even better in a Beechwood home. Google Beechwood Adelaide today for a better future for all of us.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings, 5AA Breakfast.
Good morning to you. 8:07 this morning on your Friday. David and Lucy stepping in for Will. Will and his wife Alison have had their baby, Rosie Mae Goodings.
Rosie Mae Goodings, RMG.
Very exciting. We're going to get to Breaking at 8 shortly. And don't forget, it is Meat Tray Friday today. Thanks to Dane and the team down at Blackwood Country Meats. They're at two up. Well, technically, they're across from right where we are, aren't they? Across.
You've done a Will. He always says, I'm going up to Victor Harbour for the weekend.
You know what?
You go down to Victor Harbour.
That's one of my biggest pet peeves when people say I'm going down to Clare. No, you're going 2 hours directly north, which is up.
In the same vein, you're going up to Blackwood.
You know what? I'm not entirely sure how to even get to Blackwood. So there.
Seriously?
That's Blackwood, my error. I've been
Blackwood
there.
Rules.
And I've been to this butcher, Blackwood Country Meats.
Blackwood / Belair / Coro, as it's known. None of the residents call it Coromandel Valley. It's Coro. It could almost secede from South Australia. It's like its own little universe.
It is a lovely part of the world.
I've got a lot of mates who went to Blackwood High, and Blackwood High's got a real culture all of its own, I think.
Well, they've thankfully provided our meat tray today. We would love to hear from you about who or what situation you were named after, a relative, a celebrity, a random...
Messages like this one on the Automasters text line from Dave. This is a good message, and what a great bit of parenting too. Good morning, Dave and Lucy. My son is named Freely after Ace Freely from Kiss. How good's that? I won't try to sing all of the guitar lines.
Didn't mind that, though.
Loving you, but good on you, Dave. Great work. And good on little Freely, too.
Time for Breaking at 8.
Now, this morning in Breaking at 8, we're going to take a frivolous but completely excellent and entertaining departure from the hard news cycle to shed some more light on the very happy news. And that there's not enough good news stories around. We love good news stories. And locally, for us here at 5AA and for all of our listeners right now, the happiest story going around is the arrival of little Rosie Mae Goodings yesterday.
Very exciting.
Joining us is a man who will now be known henceforth, not as the GG, but as the GGG, Grandpa Graham Goodings. G'day, Graham. How are you, mate?
Tendo, Lucy. Good morning. Yeah.
pretty exciting in the Goodings household at the moment, I can tell you.
Graham, now this is your second grandchild. You've now got two granddaughters. You're going to be overrun.
Yeah, well, it's a change in the Goodings family because I was in the midst of a run of 22 boys in a row in the Goodings family. So all of a sudden, that run's come to a grinding halt.
And, 22 in a row?
It was just quite remarkable. But our first granddaughter, Elodie, broke the run, and our second granddaughter, Rosie, has continued it. I'm loving it.
Oh, it's becoming a parent is something that everyone who has had kids says it's the greatest thing in your life. But becoming a grandparent, even not just for the first time, but for the second time, it must be a sort of uniquely special and different sort of feeling, Graham.
Pembo, it's interesting. Before we became grandparents, and even I had to wait a long time, people said, you love your kids, but there's something about your grandchildren. It's love on a whole new level. And it's true. Mm. I mean, you always love your kids, and they're always special. But I tell you what, grandchildren, you know, they just have a very special place. I guess you've got more time for them. I guess that, you know, you don't have the sort of the day-to-day to-ings and fro-ings that you do as a parent. So when you have your grandchild with you, it's a special time. And, you know, we've treasured it with Elodie, and we're really looking forward to getting to know Rosie.
Graham, how soon is it going to be before you introduce her to the world of media? Graham, you've been a part of 5AA Breakfast. Will, obviously, like, is one of us about to lose our jobs on the breakfast show here for Rosie? I mean, I wouldn't mind that.
Well, it's interesting you say that, Lucy, and you'll be doing a great job, by the way.
Let me jump in. If anyone loses their job, it's going to be me, given the response that the listeners are having to Lucy. It'll be the Lucy and Rosie show, not the Pembo and Rosie show.
There's room for everyone. We did FaceTime with Will and Alison and Rosie yesterday, and Will has already had long chats with Rosie. Evidently, she's a conversationalist already, so... Being a broadcaster and outspoken is in the gene.
Excellent. She's got a desk already set up here at 5AA with a microphone with her name on it, just about.
Has she got a size 000 Indiana Pacers singlet as well?
Look, if Will's got anything to do with it, she will, but she is certainly going to be a Crow supporter, I can tell you that.
Oh, yes. No, that's sort of... part of the contract in the Goodings household.
Now, Graham, we don't need to go into too many details about the hospital visit, but are Will and Alison just well and happy and over the moon? They're all good there?
They certainly are. We spoke to them yesterday, as I said, on FaceTime. They're looking incredibly well. Will has done an incredible job. He said he did all the hard yards. But, I think we know
sure he did.
He says that about this show too.
Yeah.
But no, Alison was looking really well. They're so excited. And in fact, I couldn't believe how well Alison was after enduring what you go through with childbirth. But and I know you're hanging out for the time of birth. I can't give you that.
Oh, no.
The
suspense. It was around lunchtime.
Yeah, so...
Oh, so Greg from West Croydon is in the box seat, but we can't officially call it until we get the official time. He was 11:45 a.m.
That's up to Will. We've put calls into Will, but he's probably got other things that are more important at the moment. Right.
I've actually lost count of how many times we have asked Will individually for the time of birth. But that's all right. We'll get it, and someone will win the Foodland voucher by pure chance.
Yeah, well, I think in the range of priorities, probably the time of birth is the last thing that he's worrying about at the moment.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, no, we know. It's purely for selfish reasons.
Yeah, exactly. Hey, Graham, look, congratulations to the entire Goodings family. And, say good day to Alison and to Will. And when you get in to see her probably over the weekend, little Rosie May, good on you, mate.
We're looking forward to it. Thanks for the call, guys. Have a great morning.
Thanks, Graham. That's good.
So there we go. It remains unresolved. It's probably going to go into next week.
Oh, my God.
Greg from West Croydon, Jane from Edwardstown, Steve from Adelaide still in with a silly chance.
It's just the absolute suspense.
Because he was 10:20. Steve was 10:20. Greg from West Croydon was 11:45. You'd almost say Greg's got it. But, Greg, if you're listening, mate, we're going to keep you hanging.
We can't officially crown a winner yet. I mean, the name was suspenseful enough. Now we're just wanting to dish out this Foodland voucher.
I'll tell you what, Luce, you have to buy a Powerball ticket for next week.
The name,
you got the name and the day.
And you know what? I was the closest out of our inner team, so I will take that. Of course, Will's beautiful new baby Rosie is the inspo for our meat tray today, thanks to Blackwood Country Meats. We're asking you who or what or, well, tell us why you were named, what you were named. Michael in Morfett Vale, good morning.
Good morning, how are you?
Good, thank you.
My son, we named him Atticus.
Atticus?
Yeah.
There's definitely a story there.
Is what that is after it? Atticus Finch?
That's correct, that's right.
You know,
Silver Mockingbird.
Some friends of ours call their son Atticus as well.
Yeah, it's a pretty rare name, but yeah, we like it.
Atticus. It's a beautiful name, Atticus.
Excellent. Thank you, Michael. Leah's in Cheltenham. Good morning to you.
Good morning, Ruthie and Dave. Yes, my story is I was named after my nonna, Elizabetha, and Dad, when I was born, said that's what, you know, he wanted his first name was, and Mum said, okay, you can have Elizabetha, but I like Miranda. And she said, well, you know, that's what I'll call her. So from then on, by relatives and that, I was called, well, in Italian, Miranda, and nobody else called me Elizabetha.
There you go.
Excellent.
Excellent, yeah. Liz. Thank
Sounds
you.
Lovely. Elizabetha.
Raylene in Paraka, good morning.
Good morning. I'd like to tell you that I was named after my dad's bit on the side. She was his bit on the side for quite a time. She produced two children besides the six others that he already had. So I was called Raylene Mary. My mother wanted Gillian Mary, which I think is much nicer. But I've still got the watch that he obviously bought for her, a very expensive watch, and it says on the back, to Ray, with love, Brian, and it says the year. And she must have given up on him by that stage, so I got it.
There you
go. I tell you what, Raylene, that sounds like quite a swinging scenario for something that probably happened quite a few decades ago.
Mother, but I think she would have gladly given him to the other woman permanently.
Raylene in Paraka, thank you very much.
How do you even start that conversation?
Oh, my gosh.
How do you say to your wife, look, if it's all right with you, I'd like to name our child after the woman I've been secretly sleeping with for 5 years?
Yeah, golly. We ask for stories.
That is a wild call, Raylene.
And our listeners are delivering. We will squeeze in one more before the break. Good morning, Lenny in Clapham.
Morning.
How are you going, Lenny?
Good.
Have you got a story about your own name?
Well, my middle name is named after Goodluck Johnson, the Nigerian president.
The Nigerian president?
What was his name, sorry, Lenny?
Goodluck Jonathan.
Goodluck Johnson.
Goodluck Jonathan.
Goodluck Jonathan. So you're called Lenny Goodluck?
Yes.
What a great name.
That's excellent.
And do you
what's
think
your
it's...
brother's middle name?
And my brother's middle name is Makepeace. Named after William Makepeace Thackeray.
He was a writer, wasn't he?
Yeah.
So you've got your good luck and he's Makepeace.
Correct.
I'm a bit
and have you had good luck so far in life, Lenny?
Most of the time.
Lenny, I've got a bizarre question for you. Are you a Crows supporter by any chance?
No.
Ah, well, my story's now redundant, but I was going to say Tom Duday's new puppy is called Lenny.
Well, there you go. There's a connection.
There you
hey,
go.
That's a great call, Lenny.
Thank
Lenny,
you so
good
much,
luck.
Lenny.
Good
excellent.
Luck to Lenny.
I'm a big fan of the name Lenny
hey,
as well.
Regardless of who wins Meat Trail, let's send little Lenny a 5AA breakfast mug.
Yeah, for sure.
Just
thanks
to prove that he
Lenny.
Has had good luck.
That's right. He's well deserving of it. Let's get to traffic now. Bruce Abernathy coming up shortly about the new car show starting tomorrow on Channel 7. Traffic with summer just around the corner. Beat the rush. Get your air conditioning sorted now with Mannix.
Thanks, Lucy. The run-in is as smooth as butter today. No great hassle. Simply some works to keep in mind. Got a lane closed at Seaview Downs. That's Majors Road near Ocean Boulevard. Also another lane out of action at College Park. That's Paynham Road near George Street. And we're slow going at Netley Marion Road near Harvey Avenue. Cameras look out for today. Port Road, Cheltenham and Tolmer Road at Elizabeth Park. Hungry? Head to Oporto for the 5 for $5 chicken strips. 5 delicious crispy chicken strips with your choice of dipping sauce. Just $5 only at Oporto. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA. Rowie.
You're watching the 5AA live stream, thanks to Foodland.
Don't ask me what tears. Will they be tears of joy or despair?
4 p.m. weekdays on 5AA.
The 88 O'Connell exclusive townhouse release is now selling. Step up your lifestyle in these luxuriously crafted homes with private walk-up entry and Centenary Street access. Be part of this incredible development. Just a short stroll to the city, Adelaide Oval, and the best of North Adelaide's culinary and retail shopping. All the benefits of the 88 O'Connell lifestyle, but in your own private sanctuary. These exclusive townhouses are now selling. Visit 88oconnell.com. There's one family in SA that's been poolside longer than any other, the Rainwise Pool family. And believe it or not, they're just as busy installing award-winning pools in the cooler months as they are in the summer. So if you don't want to be stuck standing under a sprinkler where your pool should be this summer, you really need to book your Rainwise pool install now. There's still spaces available. And remember, Rainwise pools take care of everything. Visit rainwise.com.au.
G'day, it's Baz from Fleurieu Milk Company. Just wanted to make sure you knew that our milk only comes from SA dairy farmers. So make sure the milk you buy is only from SA dairy farms. Because you see, no matter how tough it gets out there, our dairy farmers always put you first. So let's support them. Look for Fleurieu Milk Company products in your supermarket. Three words make all the difference. Fleurieu Milk Company. South Australian first and proud of it.
At Steinborner, it's always been well worth the trip. Now we're evolving to include Steinborner Electric, where it's well worth the trip to the future. With Hyundai, Kona, Kona Extended Range, Ioniq Electric and Ioniq 5. Mitsubishi Eclipse Cross Plug-in Hybrid, all-new Outlander Plug-in Hybrid, Ford Escape BEV and e-Transit. And now the new Benzina Zero Electric Scooters and Mopeds. Thinking electric vehicles? There's only one place to go. Steinborner Electric. It's well worth the trip to the future.
Bonus local delivery on selected Australian-made mattresses at Harvey Norman. Spend over $999. King Coil by AH Beard, Sleepmaker and CB Posturepedic. Plus 60 months interest-free, no deposit finance from Latitude with 60 approximately equal monthly payments and receive a bonus gift card up to $1,000. Finance only available if you have or are approved for a participating Latitude credit card. Minimum financed amount $1,000. See T's and C's. Interest applies for non-compliance. Fees and product exclusions apply. In-store purchases only. Bonus local delivery on selected Australian-made mattresses at Harvey Norman.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings.
5AA Breakfast.
Good morning to you. 8:22 for your Friday.
Now, I just want to dangle this little tantalising tidbit in front of our listeners, because after 8:30, I can confirm that we will be revealing the birth time and the winner of the $250 food lamb voucher. So stick around.
Thank goodness for that. Really, I got to the bottom of it. The suspense was getting to me.
Been one of the toughest journalistic tasks that I've ever been involved with, but I've got the story I will be revealed.
In my 5-year career, me also. We've got Bruce Abernathy in the studio this morning. Good morning, Bruce.
Good morning. Pleasure to be here.
Now great to have you in, Bruce.
Well, it's good that Will's not here.
Yeah.
Three weekends on 7 years and he's off.
Yeah, no, he showed a prodigious work ethic early on, hasn't he?
Well, as you know, we don't do all that much. Full credit to his wife, Alison. Well done. I was just worried if the kid was a boy, he'd be called Bruce.
Yeah, well, that's right.
But the good news is Rosanna Mangiarelli, who we were all saying the baby was named after, she's got a dog called Bruce.
So, that's right, you got your way in there somehow still.
It is incestuous at seven, don't worry.
That's nice.
Well, yeah, I'd be happy with the dog. You know, that's something.
I'd love a dog. Yeah, that's right.
It's an ugly dog.
Now, Bruce, you've got a new show starting tomorrow morning. If you're up bright and early, 8 a.m., I believe, The Car Club.
Yeah, it's Mark Soderstrom and I. We're a bit of a car nuts. And earlier in the year, we got offered a McLaren for a couple of days. Now, took 0.1 of a second to go, okay, if we have to. We got to go on a drive day, and we actually thought, well, why don't we film this? And it sort of evolved, and then, of course, the V8s were announced coming back to South Australia, the last race of the season for the next 5 years guaranteed, back to the streets of Adelaide, and I can remember how big they were. In fact, I'm old enough I can remember how big the Formula One was. And the V8s were almost twice as popular in terms of people attending. So it's back here. So it became almost a snowball rolling down a hill and gathering speed, and spoke to the powers that be at Seven, and they've said, look, we'll get you a slot. It's on Seven Mate, which is national coverage, which is fantastic. And they also repeat on Monday afternoon at 1:40, and also on Seven Plus, which is streaming for those the younger people who seem to watch all their TV on that as well.
So what's the format of it, Bruce? Is it like a sort of Top Gear type show? Is it like you do zany pranks where you're driving the car off jetties and things like that?
I wish it was a Top Gear format with a Top Gear budget, but people always ask that, and I say... No one watched Top Gear for the first three seasons. It actually took a long time to get that ball rolling.
Yeah, it was like a cult show for a long time.
Yeah, in the end, it was almost an entertainment show, not a car show.
Yeah, totally.
And it revolved around the relationship with the people. We're starting out. We all love our cars. Amelia Molko, our weather, she's on board. She grew up with her dad making hot rods, and they'd go to hot rod shows all over the place, and that was her upbringing with cars. She loves her car. Mark Soderstrom's father is in the Hall of Fame for drag racing in Australia.
I didn't know.
So Soders was around cars as well. And I'm just a car nufty. I just walk home from Pennington Primary past ROH, and the managing director got an XJ Jag, and I was about 7 years old, and all I wanted was a car like that. And I've actually got a pastel blue one from the 60s in my shed now. So it's
all the timber panelling. And
all that. And when I sit in it, I'm 7 years old again. But everyone has a first car. David, what was your first car? What's your favourite memory?
My first car was a Mini, and it was my mum's car, and I bought it off her for $1,000. I used to love driving that car, particularly in the hills. Minis are good to drive.
Well, they won Bathurst.
Yeah, they're great cars.
Up against the V8s back then. Well, if you put a wheel on each corner of a brick, even I, not as an engineer, know it's going to handle pretty well. Yeah. And that's what a Mini was.
Yeah.
But we all have great memories of our first car, the car we've got now. We all have a dream car. So basically, if you have any interest in anything automotive, there's something on the show for you. We go out to, we've discovered already in South Australia, great car credibility and history here with Holden's, with Mitsubishi and Chrysler, with the Formula One, as I mentioned.
Well, it's good timing too with the V8s coming back.
100%.
There's a lot of genuine excitement about that.
Oh, 100%. But one of our regular segments is we go into a man cave, or in the first episode, we call it a she shed because the owner is Fiona and she's got five Monaros in the shed.
Oh, wow.
And her and her husband, Don, it's basically that's the glue that's held them together forever, is their love of cars.
Five Monaros, that'd be worth probably $1 million.
There you go, right. Yep.
That'd be about 200 grand each?
Depending what model they are. So they've got a couple of newer ones.
Yeah, right.
They've got a couple of the older ones. And my favourite in the shed is they've got a push bike. That's a Monaro push bike. That's called marketing. Merch. When the Monaro name came back, Holden's GMH just went, let's put Monaro on everything.
Yeah.
But like you say, the V8s coming back here is probably the one thing that's really rolled that snowball faster. And we wanted to get the six shows up before Christmas, leading up to the V8 weekend here. And we've got six shows after Christmas as well. And looking forward to covering all things automotive, in particular future. I've driven an electric car and I've become a convert now.
Mm.
The argument about where the electricity comes from we can have forever, but that's not the point.
Well, how much it costs to replace the battery.
and I love that everyone comes up with the 0 to 100 kilometre speed, which no one ever does.
No.
We drove this SUV that beats Ferraris, Porsches and Lamborghinis. And your kids and the dog are jammed against the back window because you've taken off that fast. So it's a lot of entertainment. It's fun. It's looking. It's taking the pee out of ourselves. And you know, we all have a love affair with a car, a dream car. Mm. You know, we're lucky enough to drive some. And like I say, in the first show tomorrow, we got lent a McLaren. And about 15 minutes in, Soders was the navigator. I'll point this out. We were lost. And of course, McLaren are tracking the $800,000 car, realising that two idiots have gone the other way reasonably quickly. It all ended well.
Excellent. Well, it sounds absolutely great, Bruce. We look forward to watching it.
8 a.m. tomorrow morning. It kicks off the Car Club on 7Mate and 7Plus. Thanks for coming in, Bruce.
My pleasure. Thank you very much.
Cheers, mate.
Patience pays off, especially if you've been holding out for a great deal on a new Volkswagen. Mawson Lakes Volkswagen is now receiving truckloads of new Volkswagens. Yes, they're coming. And they're available at amazing prices. Remember Mawson Lakes Volkswagen for servicing too, with next day servicing and free loan cars. Get a great deal on Volkswagen now. Don't dilly-dally, dawdle or delay. Mawson Lakes Volkswagen, just a short drive from the city.
Do you want fresh filtered water flowing through your home? Choose a system by Complete Home Filtration. Joining me from Complete Home Filtration is Suzanne Dodds, who incidentally won the Telstra 2022 Business Awards. So what's the benefits of filtered water, Suzanne?
Well, the benefits of filtering water for the whole home mean that you don't just enjoy filtered water for drinking, but for showering and bathing as well. So people see big differences in softer skin, softer hair, unlimited bottled water quality water from every tap.
That sounds great. So where can we purchase one?
You can just jump online and go to completehomefiltration.com.au.
That's completehomefiltration.com.au.
Taste, feel, see the difference.
Save up to $30,000 on premium upgrades when you build with Rivergum Homes. Choose from up to 27 quality options and upgrade your home and your life with stylish kitchen appliances and stone bench tops, home automation, premium flooring, and a solar energy pack with EV charger. But for a limited time only, go to rivergumhomes.com.au or visit any of our displays at Seaford, Parafield, Anglevale, Playford Alive or Mount Barker. Terms and conditions apply.
Now here's a question. Have you been living in a dysfunctional relationship with your home appliances?
Well, I didn't think so, but maybe I do harbour some resentment towards my own oven or your oven out there for not being hot enough anymore.
Or maybe your fridge isn't as cool as it used to be.
Or if your kettle or any other of your kitchen appliances have got you boiling over, you'll be very pleased to know that Spartan's once a year renovator sale is on right now.
We love Spartan Electrical. This is Adelaide's biggest appliance sale and it's on for 3 days only. You'll get huge store-wide savings on big brand kitchen, laundry and outdoor appliances.
You won't get better priced appliances anywhere else in Adelaide this weekend.
So head in for the huge savings, stay for the barbecue, the kids' treats and the cooking demos.
Spartan's once a year renovator sale, back for 3 days only, on now, must end Sunday, only at Spartan Electrical, Campbelltown and Torrensville.
This is Adelaide's 5AA.
Partly cloudy, 23 today with the 8:30 news. I'm Mel Usher. There's been a fatal hit run. It happened on the Old Princess Highway at Murray Bridge East around 9:45 last night. A 40-year-old woman was killed. Investigations to locate the vehicle are continuing. A man's been arrested following a pursuit through the northern suburbs last night. A stolen grey Volkswagen Tiguan was spotted in Paraka and followed by patrols and from the air. Senior Constable Kimberly Broad says the driver eventually dumped the car on King's Road at Paralowie.
The driver fled but was quickly arrested by patrols in the backyard of a nearby home. So we've got a 35-year-old man of no fixed address. He's been arrested and charged with illegal use of a motor vehicle, dangerous driving to escape police pursuit and several other matters, but he didn't apply for bail, so he'll be appearing in court today.
The vehicle had been stolen during a break-in at Campbelltown on Sunday morning. The UK Prime Minister has quit after a turbulent 45 days in office. Liz Truss notified King Charles of her departure and will remain as caretaker Prime Minister. She's now the shortest serving PM in British history. She spoke outside Downing Street about her exit.
This will ensure that we remain on a path to deliver our fiscal plans and maintain our country's economic stability and national security. I will remain as Prime Minister until a successor has been chosen.
It's an anxious wait for Medibank customers to see if their personal medical information will be leaked following the cyber attack. The personal records could be made public as the insurer is held to ransom, with concerns individuals will become the target of blackmailers. Medibank is working with federal police. A set of governance principles on cybersecurity has been released to help companies protect their data in the wake of recent breaches. The guides provide a framework across five key areas, including incorporating cyber into risk management. The Australian Institute of Company Directors Chief Executive Mark Rigotti says the guides will help minimise cyber threats.
What they're trying to do is to bring forward some practical things that boards of companies can do to meet the cyber security threat, and really sort of just put down some red flags to identify where things might not be quite right.
Now turning to 5AA Sport.
10-year warranty and 10-year capped price servicing at Agostino Mitsubishi, Nailsworth and Elizabeth.
And it's over to Tom Wren.
Thank you, Mel. Round 9 in the AFLW kicks off today with Adelaide taking on Geelong at Unley Oval. Crows captain Chelsea Randall is out with an ankle injury, but coach Matthew Clark says she'll support her teammates from the sidelines.
She's pretty loud and vocal from the stands. She missed a few games last year, but it was like she was still out there, so I imagine she'll still be having that influence. And clearly her leadership around the group is as good as there is in the Caper.
Meantime, Ross Lyon could be confirmed as St Kilda's coach as early as today. To cricket, and Australia's players will fine-tune today ahead of tomorrow's T20 World Cup opener against New Zealand. The Aussies are the defending champions. Meantime, South Australia will also be in action in a one-dayer today against Queensland. Make that Tasmania, rather. Now let's go to soccer. Leicester's resurgence has continued following a 2-0 win against Leeds at home this morning. The Foxes scoring both goals in the first half to secure all 3 points.
Here is Harvey Barnes. It's 2-0 Leicester. Harvey Barnes doubles Leicester's lead. And Brendan Rodgers' team might be moving off the foot to the Premier League table tonight.
Yeah, that's exactly what they've done. Audio thanks to Optus. Earlier, Fulham smashed Aston Villa 3-0, while in the Europa League, Arsenal beat PSV Eindhoven 1-0 to maintain its perfect record in the competition. And 11-time Group 1 winner and last year's Melbourne Cup winner, Very Elegant, has been retired from racing. And that's the 5AA Sport.
Now checking 5AA traffic.
She's looking really good for the driving today. Shouldn't have any hassles on a Friday morning on the roads, which is great. Do have roadworks to keep in mind. However, got a lane closed at West Lakes. That's West Lakes Boulevard near Brebner Drive. Slow going at the moment at Birkenhead, the Portner Expressway near Victoria Road. Speeds are reduced there. And we've also got a lane closed at Eastwood Glen Osmond Road near Davies Street. Got a camera lookout for too. St Vincent Street's at Port Adelaide. Is traffic holding you back from work? Not in the new Renault Traffic. It's the work van with big space for big things. Test drive the new Renault Traffic today. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Now the 5AA forecast, 23 today and partly cloudy. A shower or two tomorrow, 21. Sunday, a shower or two, 18. Monday, a possible shower, also 18. Right now, it's 20 degrees. More news as it happens on 5AA.
What will you look forward to when you take the first step to great retirement living? Many people who make the move to an Aveo retirement community speak of the feeling of belonging, looking forward to trying new activities and making new friends, finding a place that truly is home. It may feel daunting to start with, but the friendly team at Aveo are here to help you make the decision that's right for you. One with a little relief, less worries, and a whole lot more looking forward to life. Search Aveo First Step to book a discovery tour.
5AA Breakfast is streaming live right now. To watch, simply head online to 5AA Facebook or search 5AA on YouTube. David Penberthy and Will Goodings, 5AA Breakfast.
Good morning to you, 8:36. In a moment, we are chatting to the CEO of the Australian Petroleum and Energy Association. But in exciting news, David, we have tracked the man down, William Goodings.
This has been quite the task, but we have found him.
He'll be on shortly.
So to those of you who are still in the race for the $250 food land voucher, and also obviously the more important aspect to the story is, of course, the miracle of creation, the arrival of Rosie May. We'll be discussing that too, but equally importantly, the $250 food land hamper will be going off. Hey, plenty of mayhem down the road this week at the Adelaide Convention Centre with the farrago of ratbaggery on evidence, full display by our good friends at Extinction Rebellion. No buttocks being glued to the footpath this time, but a few pairs of hands. People called oilies who were covered in makeshift fake grease boarding the Glenelg tram for some unfathomable reason. A total of 9 arrests were made. Before we talk to our next guest, I just want to read out some quotes here. I think this is the most intelligent thing, and I say this in all seriousness and sincerity, that anybody in the Australian Labor Party has said for a long time. The quotes come from the State Energy and Mining Minister, Tom Koutsantonis, who was at the Asia-Pacific Oil and Gas Conference this week. He said that the actions of Extinction Rebellion jeopardise attempts to bring middle Australia with us on a decarbonisation route. He said, I was there to tell the Oil and Gas Industry Conference that the need to decarbonise is coming at them at a million miles an hour. We need to start decarbonising now, but the protesters aren't interested. And then he made the excellent point that what he was most intrigued by was their use of hydrocarbons to glue themselves to fixtures and fittings. They should practice what they preach. And none of them walked there, they would have been driven there. Well, Sam McCulloch is the new CEO of the Australian Petroleum Production and Exploration Association, and she's in Adelaide at the moment. Samantha, good morning, and thank you for your time. You just heard those comments that our minister here, Tom Koutsantonis, made. What would you say to your critics who say that the industry just doesn't get it and doesn't care about the planet?
Good morning, David. And look, let me just say that the industry and the oil and gas industry that I represent is actually committed to net zero. So the protests that we saw this week and that we saw at the conference yesterday are in fact deeply counterproductive, because most of the discussion that we were having was about how the oil and gas industry is contributing to emissions reductions, contributing to our climate goals and to net zero. And as I said, my industry, the oil and gas industry, is deeply committed to emissions reductions. We have set a 2050 net zero target across the industry, and many of my members are actually set even more ambitious targets to achieve net zero. And we're investing in the billions of dollars in the projects and the technologies that are actually needed to deliver real emissions reductions.
I reckon, like most of our listeners, Lucy and I, we're people who believe in climate change, and we're excited by the work that's being done in the renewable sector here in South Australia. We've become world leaders on that score with solar and wind. But the reality is that where we are placed right now as a country, we're not quite ready yet to rely solely on renewables to meet all of our household and business needs, are we?
Well, blessed with abundant energy resources, and that includes fantastic, you know, solar and wind resources, and we should be deploying solar and wind as hard and fast as possible. But we do also still need gas, for example, to support that deployment of renewables. And we're seeing this across Australia, but also across the world currently, where as we're moving away from reliance on coal and while we're ramping up renewables, gas is playing the most important role really it's ever played in the energy mix. And it will continue to play that role in the energy mix because we need gas as a backup and as firming for that renewables deployment in the power system.
Hmm. Samantha McCulloch, the CEO of the Australian Petroleum Production and Exploration Association. Thanks very much for joining us this morning on 5AA.
Thanks, David.
I think if old Coots was listening to the start of that, he might have fallen off his chair given the occasional stinks we've had with him over the years. But I actually think that his detractors, and some of them are, you know, on the conservative side, and you know, I know other people still going about his spectacular driving record. Having said all that, the Labor Party needs more people like him who are prepared to actually talk some straight, no BS, intelligent commentary about these actions, because he's dead right. I mean, every time you see someone chucking red paint on a Van Gogh painting, 100 new climate skeptics are born. The normal person looks at that and just goes, these people are just halfwits.
And then the other half just appreciate fine art.
Exactly.
On the Audiomasters text line, we've had a note, careful driving south along Main North Road just before Gawler. There is a mother duck and her ducklings cruising around on the road. God, adorable. I love baby ducks.
They are very cute.
I mean, we all know how much I love animals, but
I'm amazed, Liz, you dropped the ball today. Are we going to have have we still got time to interview someone from, you know, Western Plains Zoo or something before 9 o'clock?
No, so that was my animals mention. That's right. But in good news, we do have some more time on a slightly off note when we're discussing animals. Meat Tray Friday, when you know, the other side of meat. But anyway, and animals. Meat Tray today is thanks to Blackwood Country Meats, thanks to Dane and the team. Paul in Modbury Heights, good morning to you.
How you going, Lucy? Well done on your first couple of shows.
Thanks, Paul.
And that was very cruel. That's very cruel about saying the other side of the meat tray as well.
I know. I'm still learning how to segue things, and I took a stab with something, and it wasn't that great. But we're moving on. What's your naming story,
yes,
Paul?
We will. Okay, so my son is named Eli. My wife liked the voice of a particular contemporary Christian singer back in the day when he was born. To only find out that she thought his name was Eli, so we named our son after him, only to find out his name was actually Toby.
What was Eli, like his stage name or something?
No.
He just got his name wrong.
Yes, he got it completely wrong. We liked the name Eli, we thought it sounded great, but then we said, oh, we named him after him, and
no,
that guy's named Toby.
That's all right. Eli. We got a story out of it.
Eli's cooler than Toby.
Yeah, that's right. Oh, it is. It's a cool name.
Yeah, Eli's very unique. Thank you, Paul. Let's go to Steve down in Hackham. Good morning.
Good morning, guys. I've got a real funny one for you. I was born in Broken Hill in 1952, and my mother told me the story later on that the woman next to her didn't know what to call her son, and it was around about the same time as the Melbourne Cup. I was born on the 12th of November. Anyhow, she ended up calling her son the winner of the Melbourne Cup. His name is Dowray.
Dowray?
Yeah, Dowray won the Cup in 1952, so somewhere around Western New South Wales, if he's still alive, there's a bloke called Dowray.
How do you spell that, Steve?
Dalray. I did Google it many years ago, and... That's correct. He did win by a long nose.
Hey, that's good. Dalry.
Excellent.
Dalry. That works as a name.
Definitely does. Thank
Better
you,
than
Steve.
Being called, you know, Kingston Town or Winx.
Maccabi Diva.
Maccabi
Diva Penberthy.
Rolls off the tongue.
Oh, you know, you've got to write that on your passport form when you're coming in.
Oh, absolutely.
Automasters text line here, one from Quentin. He was named after Uncle Quentin in the Enid Blyton Famous Five books. My mum was reading the books to my siblings while she was pregnant. Lucky she wasn't reading The Addams Family. Yeah, Quentin, you could have been called Cousin It.
Oh, that's right. And our good friend Tessa in Paraka, legend has it that I'm named after Tessa the D'Urbervilles after my parents saw the Polanski film and felt inspired. Roman Polanski, there's a man who's got a pretty ignoble personal history. We had a Rosemary before, reminded me of another Polanski film, Rosemary's Baby. That was a Roman Polanski film, I think. Have you seen that movie?
No, but I believe you that it is.
It's terrifying.
At the end of these 2 weeks, I'm going to have the longest list of movies that I need to watch purely from all our texts and mentions because I just haven't seen many. So
today's homework tasks for you, Lisa, you have to watch Pulp Fiction and Rosemary's Baby.
I'll see what I can do.
All right.
Let's check fuel watch. Download the free My RAA app today to find the cheapest fuel in an instant. If you're in the north, $1.69 at the X Convenience on Main North Road in Prospect. If you're in the east, also $1.69 at the Ampol on Kensington Road in Kensington. If you're in the south today, $1.69 at the Ampol on Sandpiper Crescent in Aberfoyle Park. And if you are in the west, $1.71 at the airport. Cheapest diesel, $2.32 at the OTR on Tapleys Hill Road in Seaton.
$2.32. It was $2 somewhere yesterday. It's gone up 30 cents in 24 hours.
Yeah, diesel I think is ranging all over the city, but if you are in Seaton, you'll find it for $2.32, so maybe you'd have a bit of a scoot around and see if you can find one below that.
Yeah, you're doing your day there.
See where the cheapest fuel is in an instant with the free My RAA app. Download it today. Let's check traffic for your drive into work on this Friday with summer just around the corner. Beat the rush and get your air conditioning sorted now with Mannix.
Air conditioning.
Thanks, Lucy. Roads looking really good for the driving today. No hassles at all, which is excellent. However, do have some roadworks to keep in mind today. That lane closed at Eastwood. That's Glen Osmond Road near Davey Street. Speeds are reduced. We're slow going for works at Brighton at the moment. Brighton Road near Edward Street. Quite busy. Tapleys Hill Road at Glenelg North. And we've got cameras at Whites Road, Parralowie and Purling Avenue at Edinburgh. Scottish singer-songwriter Lewis Capaldi returns to Australia in 2023 and Amex card members get access to pre-sale tickets from October 25. Search Amex Experiences. T's and C's apply. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Everyday low prices, any time of year. Trust the mighty South Aussies.
Great food. You're watching the 5AA live stream. Thanks to Foodland.
Visit citydiscounttires.com.au to find your nearest tour. City Discount Tires. We're driven by value.
FIVEAA's Tech Talk with your host, Adelaide Tech Guy Richard Pascoe. Thanks to Harvey Norman Computers.
Last month, we spoke about the best new laptop of 2022, HP's Envy X360. Well, it just got better. Harvey Norman has added a special new bonus. Not only do you get a 2-for-1 device that has a flip screen to make it more like a tablet, and fast, reliable computing with 16 gig of RAM and a 512 gig solid-state drive. On top of all these incredible specs, you'll also score a bonus $300 Harvey Norman gift card, the perfect excuse to grab some accessories or even treat yourself to a new coffee machine. All yours with a beautifully designed HP Envy. Available now at Harvey Norman for only $1,999.
Check out this great offer at 5AA.com.au. Thanks to Harvey Norman Computers.
Sold by McGain again.
And because homes continue to sell quickly, it's important to get along to these open inspections, especially so for this stunning home, which is fresh to the market. Now, I've had a look at this myself online. I was looking at it last night, not because I'm going to try to buy it. I'm quite happy with the house that I've got. But I tell you what, if you've got a big family and you've got a bit of cash to throw around, this house is absolutely stunning. I understand it's being sold by a keen 5AA listener too. Now, get along tomorrow from 1:30 to 2. Kane Dover and Pete Fallon, they're opening 2 Cowrie Parade in Seacliff. It's a 1948 beachside manor on a whopping 1,146 square metre block, 4 streets back from the beach. This home's actually basically two houses rolled into one. The main house features four bedrooms, two bathrooms, two massive living areas, a functional fireplace, a beautiful fire pit out the back, and one of the biggest bookshelves you'll ever see. Outside of the main home, there's a fully self-contained granny flat with private access and driveway, making it perfect for guests or an Airbnb. Best offer by November 7, price guide $1.8 million plus.
Take a look at this amazing property and all the Magain listings at magain.com.au.
Callum here for Edwards Sound Mazda with amazing news. We have the incredible Mazda CX-9 in stock ready for immediate delivery. Reserve yours now and ask about our 5-day turnaround promise. Only at Edwards Sound Mazda. It's gotta be. LMBD 207428.
Kate Collins and Brendan Radless. The faces you know and the team you can trust. Nine News. Made in Adelaide for Adelaide.
David Penberthy and Will Goodings.
5AA Breakfast.
8:50. Lucy and David. Lucy, myself, I shouldn't say in third person, but I am replacing Will Goodings for 2 weeks, who is currently enjoying his first 24 hours of paternity leave. And we've tracked you down, Will. We've been waiting for so long to have this conversation. Congratulations to you and Alison. How are you?
Oh, I'm great, Luce. Thank you. Well, it's lovely to speak to you and David and then Sam a moment ago and Craig, our boss, yesterday as well. You know, I'd like to generally have a bit of a thought about what I'm going to say whenever I come on air beforehand and we film a video or do something. My brain is scrambled eggs.
Have you had any sleep at all?
I had a little bit of sleep. Not much, as David will tell you. And anyway, is that a parent nodding along at home at the moment will tell you. Feeding is apparently quite a regular occurrence, so that happens often. And thankfully, with the help of the excellent staff at Ashford, because Alison and I have no idea what we're doing at the moment. But you know, the most incredible 24 hours of my life, I think. And there's no word of an exaggeration.
It is genuinely overwhelming, isn't it, mate?
Oh my God! Yeah, yesterday, and through the night, it turned out to be quite a long journey for Alison overnight, and had some twists and turns over it. Everything worked out for the best. Everyone's okay in the end, but it's just extraordinary what the human body can do. It's extraordinary what my wife can do, and now it's extraordinary thing that my little daughter can do.
Well, I've got to say, when I guessed the name Rosie, how annoyed were you that I actually got it one day before she was born?
Have you told our listeners?
Yep.
How you guessed it?
Oh, what do you think my opening segment was this morning?
Right, Lucy.
Lucy's self-indulgent hour.
is like Liz McCaskill concerned? You know, you've got a new job being a savant on the weekends. I mean, ring Lucy for advice. 8223-0000. We'll see what's going to happen well ahead of time.
Hey, mate, I don't want to prick your balloons. You might have a new job hosting a breakfast radio show the way she's going.
You know what? We were literally in the delivery suite, and they have such a Ashford team. I mean, everyone we dealt with, they're just geniuses, these people, and beautiful people too. They couldn't have made the whole thing more enjoyable for us, even in bits that were a little bit stressful. But there were a host of 5AA listeners in there, and all of them were at pains to tell me that Lucy was just absolutely dominating. I thought, I'm stressed enough at the moment. I don't need to be checking the classifieds when I get back in 2 weeks.
No, Will, your job is safe. Of course, if you are watching along on the Foodland Supermarket's Facebook and YouTube live stream, there will be some gorgeous baby photos of Will, Alison and little Rosie. I've got to say, Will, again, because I guessed the name, you did promise me godmother. How are we looking on that front?
Is that the deal? You can tell me anything right now and I'd believe it.
Yeah, great. Just let me know.
You did really well. Look, never play a game of, like, guess with clues with Lucy, because I forget she's sort of has some forensic law background.
After about a month,
it became clear to me, these weren't casual throwaway conversations we were having. She was, like, putting together a dossier.
It's what lawyers refer to as the discovery period, Will.
Yeah,
hey, can I ask, mate, this is our Meat Tray Friday topic today too. Is there any special significance behind your daughter's two names, or is it just a simple fact that you like the names?
but purely because we like both names. Yeah. We liked older fashioned sort of a name. That's what we pictured, and we ended up settling on it for both names, both Rosie and May. The first name, though, the poor girl, it'll be the subject that I've already got half the 21st speech written, I think. We were watching a movie called Water for Elephants, not a particularly renowned or, you know, well regarded film. Robert Pattinson and Reese Witherspoon. in it, they work at a circus. The name of the elephant at the circus is Rosie. And at the end of the movie, Alice and I both went, what a lovely name. And so somehow it morphed from there to us settling on it over the course of the next few months. And this would have been a decade ago. If we ever have a girl or a baby, we'll call her Rosie. So now she has to live with forever being known as a performing elephant, which is unfortunate.
So it's Rosie. It's not Rosemary or Rosalita.
No, Rosie. It's just Rosie. It's Rosie.
I couldn't have been more off the mark with Consuela, could I, in hindsight?
No. I mean, it came in a very close second. There was a couple of really heated conversations.
Now, Will, we have something very important to ask you.
Yes. Adelaide's 5AA. Breaking news.
We are absolutely so desperate to award this $250 Foodland voucher nearest to the pin. Can you please reveal what time little Rosie was born?
I have a horrible feeling you've won it, Lucy.
No, you know
she's
what?
She's not eligible.
I actually got so close, but no, I can't win it.
The time of birth, and this was actually news to me until I looked it up this morning, because I couldn't have told you what time was it yesterday at any point. It was 11:23 a.m.
11:23 a.m. That is good news for one listener.
Means the three guesses for October the 20th were Steve from Adelaide at 10:20 a.m., Greg from West Croydon at 11:45 a.m., Jane from Edwardstown at 4:17 p.m. So the winner, just 22 minutes off the mark, is Greg from West Croydon. Big thanks to our friends at Foodland. Greg, mate, if you are listening, you have won the $250 Foodland voucher. This is just going to be wonderful audio to play at Rosie's 21st, isn't it, Will?
Yeah, it is. The poor girl. Yeah, doesn't know what she's in for.
Hey, mate, she's a goodings. She knew that life came with a very strong likelihood that she would be in the public eye.
I thought getting a tweet from the Premier on day one was pretty good.
So, oh, yeah.
She's had a pretty good start to life, she has.
Congratulations, Will. We will catch you in 2 weeks.
Thank you.
Your job is very safe. We'll let you get back to Alison and Rosie, and we're going to award a meat tray winner shortly, but before that, let's get to John Blake with Behind Closed Doors, Aussie Fast Transport Solutions, interstate freight distribution, warehousing, local Adelaide couriers. Call 13 13 64.
And when we get behind
1395. Adelaide's 5AA. This is the Saturday Sports Show. KG and Cornsy.
Hi, folks. Welcome to the Saturday Sports Show. Graham Corns with you and an angry KG Cunningham.
Hi, Studley. How are you, son?
I'm good, Ken. What's the matter with you?
Well, Studley, all this talk about the scoreboard at Allen Oval.
Yes, you don't like the idea of that, do you?
I don't. Leave the scoreboard alone. The scoreboard is going nowhere.
But if we put a grandstand at that end of
you don't need a grandstand there. The Oval is beautiful the way it is, and that end is gorgeous. You've got the Moreton Bay Bugs and the scoreboard.
Figs, not bugs.
Whatever. Leave the Allen Oval alone.
It's a great stadium.
Well, it is, Graham. And I saw the Gary McIntosh bar for the first time the other day, just inside the Eastern Gate there, the Gary McIntosh bar.
Yes, it is good. There are a lot of good areas.
Yes, there are. What about your area, the Graham Corns barbecue?
No, it's a deck.
Well, the deck.
It's called the Graham Corns deck. I've never been on it. Well, I've been through it to have a look, but not when there's a game on.
Well, that's good, Stanley. The Graham Corns deck.
Yes, Blakey has a couple of New Zealand characters that call it something else. Not a deck, but something else.
Hi, my name's Bull.
And my name is Chiva.
And we're from New Zealand, the land of the long white cloud.
Yeah, and we love going to the Adelaide Oval and sitting on the Graham Corns deck.
Yeah, we like to have drinks and nubbles.
There's plenty of room on the Graham Corns deck.
That's right, it's a pretty big deck.
Not everyone can get on the Graham Corns deck.
No, that's because it's an exclusive deck.
Most people are surprised when they first see the Graham Corns deck.
Yes, they say, shot a brock, this is a big deck.
Isn't it funny how if we say the word pretty, it comes out all right? Because it's spilt with an E, and that's pronounced as an I in the word pretty, so it doesn't matter.
That's incredible!
This episode has been very, very silly.
Meat tray today, all thanks to Dane and the team at Blackwood Country Meats. Have we got a winner, David?
We certainly do, and I think that decades after she suffered the ignominy of being named after a racehorse that was put down the following day, The winner has to be Janelle.
Congratulations, Janelle. We will be back on Monday, but stay listening later on to Jade Robren today from 3 o'clock. Chris Jarma is joining her for the 5AA Food and Wine Show, all thanks to SMEG. David and I will see you on Monday from 6. Then.
If you're heading to the 4x4 Adventure Show at Wavell Showgrounds, visit the TJM stand in the Wavell Pavilion. They've got cracking deals on everything you need.